Smith scores for Scotland.
Roma Zheng stepping away.
Stunning work from Fridger. What an individual score this is.
Talent aplenty has graced these great leagues, but now future stars are set to shine. Last season was the most thrilling to date, but now it's time for a new crop of talent to grace the field, and in this league, anything could happen. It's time to take your seat. The best leagues in the land are back.
Was a white line seeking missile.
Loughborough score! Drives towards the line! Sensational score from Roma Zheng!
Winding to gear, drive to the line! And Cardiff are streaking across! Welcome back, everybody! Buck Super Rugby is back underway!
Welcome to the StoneX.
Yeah.
Bucks Super Rugby up first, Loughborough winning the men's title. But now for the main event, the stars of the show. It's time for the Women's National League final. Loughborough again, plenty of purple in the crowds, plenty of red too. Hartpury here to face off. Hartpury looking for a three-peat this year. Loughborough finished third in the league. And now through to the final. Their first ever of the National Women's League. And what a season it's been so far. And today it's Hartbury versus Loughborough.
All roads lead to the StoneX. Going to be an unbelievable celebration of the best leagues in the land. It's Loughborough versus Hartbury. It's Loughborough versus Exeter. I can't wait. You can't either. We'll see you there.
I'm gonna fight them all. Seven Nation Army couldn't hold me back. They're gonna rip it off, taking their time right behind my back. And a message coming from my eyes says, leave it alone.
Fourth hand, sharp hand from Burgundy.
And it's a little offload. It could work out here for Hartbury. There is the score.
Loughborough filling their boots on their way to the try line.
Edge volley slides underneath the sticks.
Yes, welcome to the StoneX. It is Women's National League Finals Day, and I'm delighted to be joined by Amelia Tutt, Leicester Tigers and Wales, Jordan Russell, Gloucester Hartbury, and Lily Ives Campion, Loughborough Lightning, and England in 20s. Girls, I went very dramatic with the opener, but it's very exciting, isn't it? This is as big as it gets for university rugby. And Lily, I'm going to come to you first, because we're talking big drama, we're talking big games, but this is rugby with your mates, isn't it, when you're playing for your uni?
Oh, it's an unbelievable occasion, and I think university rugby is really good. It's actually on the, I think it's just on the up. The league they've had this year and the games they've played have been really good, and I think this, like, both these teams got some really good depth in their squad, and they've both been playing some really great rugby.
Jordan, you've been here before with Hartbury on finals day. Big performance from you back then. What are your memories of that?
I think for me, it was like at the time the biggest stage that I've ever played on. But like you touched on before, it's playing with your friends, playing with your mates, and you make these memories, and these memories hold on for life. So I think the one thing that these girls are going to take away today is, yes, it's going to be a really competitive game, really physical game, but they're doing it with probably, arguably, some of the most loveliest friends they're ever going to meet in their lives.
Amelia, from small acorns, mighty oaks grow, the saying goes. And this league, over the years, has provided some huge international stars. So what breeding ground is Bucks Super Rugby for the men and the Women's National League for the women?
I think it's just such 40, a here we good are. Platform for people to grow on. And most people start just with having fun, and then the love for the game grows and people can aspire for bigger things. And yeah, I think it's a really good platform.
Huge platform, especially for Hartbury, who are going for a three-peat. And I think we can hear from Fordy, their head coach. He's with Joe Burns.
StoneX, another final with Hartbury. Another opportunity to add a crown to that already bulging cabinet. But I know that each one is very special and each one is very, very tough.
Yeah, I think this is the third time here for us. Really excited to be here. Feels a bit like an away day for us, obviously, with the Loughborough men doing the job before. So I think girls are preparing for a bit of noise in this game. But look, we're excited to get out there.
Well, look, well, I guess there's two things there. You know, you're talking about the noise of Loughborough, but also you're pretty familiar having made two finals before. Does the weight of that expectation of you might be able to do three in a row, how does that weigh on the squad and yourself?
I don't think the girls are focused too much on that at all. It's a new group. Yes, there's girls in this squad that have done two already. I think we can lean in slightly on that experience, hopefully, today. Loughborough, kind of new territory for them. They've been phenomenal in the back end of this season. So we'll have to see how they come out and face the final. But look, we're hoping to get out there and lean on that experience a little bit going into this game.
All right, a lot of noise, big occasion, a lot of Loughborough support. But, you know, you've got such talent in your team, a lot of girls who've played sort of PWR or Premiership Cup. So, you know, for them to be unleashed, they shouldn't be fazed by this, should we say?
No, look, I think we're very lucky in terms of our squad depth. I think I've said this week we've used about 53 players this year in the first team alone. Obviously, girls away with 20s this week. We wish them all the best. A couple of players are well seen as well, which is what we're really proud of as well. But the 23 today are here to do a job, and look, they're just as capable, and they're excited to see some of them out there.
That job is Loughborough, a Loughborough team who are in red hot form coming into this final after defeating Exeter at their place. So what is it about their threats that you need to strike out so that you guys can lift the trophy once again?
Very dangerous back three and a phenomenal nine. So if we can kind of stop those threats, slow down their ball a little bit, try and stop the wing, stop that back three getting hands on ball, that's probably the areas we're going to look to target most.
Well, we look forward to seeing out there. Go well.
Thank you very much.
40, smiley and confident. I don't think we'd expect anything else from him, would we, Jordan? I'm not getting a pang for every time I say it, but Hartbury are going for the three-peat today. How tough a task is that?
It's tough because I think the girls have been performing really consistently. You know, you hear Fordy say it, you'll hear Sean Lynn say it. The pathway at Hartbury is incredible. It's well-renowned. And when you have that sort of always in the background, you want the repeatability. You want girls to, you know, really stick in and perform well. We want to repeat, but we want to do it for the third time now. We don't want to be quite lax with it. We want to go over a really good win today, but I don't want for 1 minute for everyone to think that everyone else thinks we are going to win it. It'll be a really, really close game today.
So they're going for the three-peat, but it's Loughborough who's standing their way. Let's hear from their head coach, Katie Trevathian.
Katie, here we are. The season, it starts so long ago and this seems so long into the distance, but you're here, you're at a final, not just a final, but it's the first one since 2005 for Loughborough. How are you? How are the girls feeling? What's the build-up been like for you all?
Yeah, so build-up's been really good. It's been over Easter holiday, so the girls have spent a lot of time together, and you can tell that. We're just excited now. The girls are ready, so let's just go play.
Just go play. It's that simple. That simple. Well, you played very well against Exeter in the semi-final. There couldn't be a sterner test. Do you feel that you're as best prepared as you possibly could be for this final?
Yeah, absolutely. Like, we've built and built as the season's gone on. And as I say, the girls are just ready to play now. There's nothing else we need to do. Let's just have a crack, have a game of rugby.
Right, they say at Loughborough, it's where history begins. Your men have just created their own bit of history, winning the Bucks Super Rugby Cup final for the first time in 14 years. Are you leaning into the history that is available for you and the girls today?
Yeah, absolutely. That's been something we've talked about. And actually, like, we got to be brave. Let's play brave. And if that means we make history, we make history.
Play brave. And to be the best, you've got to beat the best. And Hartbury have certainly proven to be that over the last few years. What do you feel about playing them? What have you got to get right today?
Yeah, so for us, I think we've got to focus on us. We've got to control what we can control. And when we get an opportunity, we've got to take it.
Outstanding. Go well.
Thank you very much.
Katie talking about controlling what they can control today. It's been an up and down season, it's fair to say, for Loughborough. Have they brought things together at the right time at the tail end?
I really think they have. I mean, you either win or you learn, and I think they've really, it's evident they've taken those learnings and they're on an upwards trajectory, and I really think today they could be on the up. I think it's exciting.
How much confidence will they take from the boys doing it earlier on this afternoon? Is that something the girls will have come in and thought, oh yeah, this is our day? Will the girls have taken confidence from the men winning today?
I think so, yeah. I think they'll see what the men have done and they know that they can do the same, because they are very good players, all of them, and they're on the up. So,
Do the two of you, I'm going to pose this to both of you, do the two of you think there's any correlation between the fact that the teams that we've got in the Bucks final today and the Women's National League final today are affiliated with PWR clubs? How strengthening is that for them?
Well, I think both of us have the links with our PWR clubs, and I think it's a good platform for them to be able to merge from both, but it does take away sometimes when the girls need to play for their other team, can take away from the team sheet for that. What do you think?
I agree. I think the talent pool, the initiative is amazing, because that's when you start to see some of these girls really coming to their own, you know, like university, playing for Bucks gives that opportunity, probably opportunities at age grades. This is the first really big jump now, you know, the one true stepping stone to PWR, to women's, you know, top flight rugby. But like Amelia said, it's difficult when you're playing for more than one club. You might be affiliated, you might be dual registered. I just know that the girls want to play the best rugby they can. Sometimes you might actually find difficulties with affiliations to who you train in, what you train in, and you're going to get some girls that are really lucky to fall into both of those. But then, like I say, where do they lie? Where do they get a rest?
What can we expect from this game today? Are these two teams a good match for each other, or are they two quite competing styles of rugby, Amelia?
We think so. We were saying that we always wanted it to be a Hartbury-Loughborough final, and we think it's going to be a very good game. We were saying maybe very high scoring, tight, good game, we think.
I think it's going to be really sort of direct rugby. I think we're going to see quite a lot of strong carries. I think it's going to be, for part of the game, quite a forwards heavy game, until, you know, we get the opportunity to break away, and then we're going to see our lovely backs, both teams. I think we we play a very similar style. We want to get it out the back. We want to play rugby. You know, I wouldn't want to say we just want to hit up and see who folds first. We want to see those amazing tries and those real team tries today. And I think why we were saying earlier about, you know, a Hartbury-Loughborough Loughborough final, it's going to be, you know, the one for the ages, I do reckon.
Yeah, I think the similar style is what's going to make it quite an exciting game.
Yeah.
And is this game going to be won by halftime, or are we going to see another match like the men's earlier on this afternoon where we're all hanging on at the 80th minute?
We're in agreement. I think, you know, it'll be tight by halftime. Yeah. I agree, high scoring. Hopefully. But I reckon it'll be win or loss by 60, 70 minutes in.
I agree. I think it's going to be all for the taking.
It's definitely who keeps their heads by the 80th minute. Yeah.
Well, you've built it out beautifully for us, girls. And I think it's time that we can go and join our commentators. Dave Rogers is joined by Elizabeth Shermer and Lily Ives-Campion up on the gantry.
Thanks, LJ. It's a big one. About the biggest there is for these two teams. What a rivalry, Loughborough and Hartbury. Before we have a look at the teams, let's take a look at how they got to the final. Hartbury here for the third time in a row. Loughborough getting there for the first time. They got there with a massive victory over Durham and then a nail-biter down in Exeter. As for Hartbury, well, they won the league, so they had a bye in the quarter-final, and then they went toe-to-toe with the Archers of Cardiff Met to book their place and the opportunity for a three-peat. In terms of the teams, of course, both have been interrupted by international duty, but despite the disruption, Hartbury are able to field a great mix of experience and opportunity. Amy Dale and Evie Roach play in their second final with Dutch international Anouk Veerkamp in the front row. Sophie Davis is one of the players stepping out for the final time in the Boiler House with Gab Scove. Relying on youth in the back row, Robin Davis captains the college team, and Alau Pierce has just represented Wales in the Under-18 Six Nations Festival. Jess Kershaw has Premier 15 experience with Worcester Warriors, forming a halfback pairing with last year's final MVP Charlie May Manns. Pip Hendy has lit up the PWR on the wing. She's in the centres with Abby Lee Priestnell and Lucia Scott. Craig Rizzle Johnson all have winners medals, and Daisy Aspinall has been fantastic for England under-18s. As for Loughborough, Catherine Baverstock packs down on the Loosehead side. She is a former Hartbury College student. She comes in for Amelia Williams alongside Kendall Wardby and Isla Curfee in the front row. Izzy Winter leads the line out in the engine room with Keevy Fitzpatrick, and a back row reshuffle sees Lucy Finch move to 7, Sally Williams at 8, Maisie Johns remains at 6. Lucy Weaver has been Lightning's first choice 9 for much of the PWR season, and with Leah Greenaway, Alex Baker pulls on the 10 jersey. The centres and the back three are unchanged from the semi-final victory over Exeter. Lorne and Anderson Thomas play in their final games for the students, and Tasker, Scantlebury and Westcombe Evans all playing Premiership women's rugby this season. Well, the noise has just gone up a notch in the main stadium, and the players are in the tunnel. A fantastic occasion is upon us. It's the African Violet of Loughborough looking for an historic double. It's not been done in the Bucks Super Rugby Premiership Women's Rugby era. Although Hartpury know what it's like to taste victory at this level. So much so that they are making Loughborough wait a little bit longer to get out onto the synthetic turf here. So many stories, so much narrative. But now it is time to make a new chapter in the history of this great competition. It's the Women's National League final. It is Loughborough versus Hartbury, live from the StoneX Stadium. The warmest of welcomes to you wherever you are joining us around the world. Well, the flags are waving. The anticipation is killing us. And we got a little bit excited earlier too, because they went about 4 minutes early. But now, we are right on time. It is the Bucks Women's National League final. Two of the most famous jerseys in all of student sport, the red of Hartbury, the African Violet of Loughborough. The best of the best will be crowned champions after 80 minutes here at the home of Saracens. Hartbury, the league champions again. They won it, and they won it in style, but they didn't win it without defeat. They had an early slip-up against Exeter, and they were defeated by Loughborough. Loughborough, third place in the league. They went out in the quarter-finals to Cardiff Met last season. It was a bitterly disappointing end, but there was the sense that they were building something. Is that something? Two hands on the trophy at the end of the game here. Loughborough in African Violet, kicking off to Hartbury. The Women's National League final is underway. Will it be the three-peat, or will it be purple ribbons and a new champion? Rebecca Piddleston, the referee in charge. Elizabeth Shermer and Lily Ives-Campion joining us for this one. Now, you two, have I got a referee this one? Because you faced off against each other in the Premiership Cup this weekend.
It was a really, really great game, wasn't it? It was a really tough game. Both teams haven't played together for a long time, and I think that us coming together this weekend like made it a really good test.
Yeah, for sure, especially in the line-outs. I loved that challenge.
What about this one then, Lily? Because you played in the semi-final.
Yes.
In fact, I was in Loughborough when you came back. I could see how much that victory against Exeter meant to the group, to give this 23 players the opportunity that is before them.
Yeah, the semi-final was a really great game. I think it was a really physical test for both teams. And I think, again, it was a really quite high scoring, but really close at the end. And I think what Loughborough showed then, that hopefully they'll show today, is that physicality, and that physicality till the end. And I think, yeah, we'll see how that happens today.
Well, this is the first scrum of the match. The front rows, we've got Baverstock, Wardby and Kerfey packing down for Loughborough. Kerfey with lightning experience. For Hartbury, Amy Dale and Evie Roach at hooker and tight head. Evie Roach, one of the leaders in the group. Both of them two-time Bucks champions. And Anouk Veerkamp, a Dutch international. And Hartbury winning the penalty. Charlie May Mans, an outside half today. She played at 12 when she got player of the match in the last final. I think we can expect to see her and Abby Lee Priestnell rotate at first receiver. Right then, line-out gurus, what are we expecting in attack and defence from these first few?
I think here both teams probably going to go for calls they know that you can get, and like we can see from that, but I think just a big D from Loughborough there.
Two. Yeah, great start with the driving maul there, really on the front foot and giving them a good platform hopefully to go forward.
Penalty advantage for Hartbury. Massive opportunity for a few under-18s in the Hartbury team. Charlie Maymans drops that on the toe, looking to turn. Georgina Tasker and does, 50-22. Brilliant kick, and what an early opportunity for Hartpury.
Yeah, I think Hartbury are going to play that territory game, especially we've got a bit of wind here today. They're not going to want to play in their half, so if they can pin Loughborough back, that's what they're going to do, and hopefully go for the maul again and get some front football.
Well, the wind is in the favour of Hartbury in this first half. Amy Dale, big line out here, five in it for Hartbury. Clean ball at the front. We start to go to the maul. Dale tucks it under the right hand, starts to move forward. This really good work, strong work by the Hartbury pack, eating up the meters. And Jess Kershaw finds Veerkamp. Veerkamp tips it on one more. Hartbury working towards the post, first journey into the 22. Gemma Bell, she's made massive progress in the last 12 months to earn her right to play in this final. That was Evie Roach with the carry. Now Charlie Maymans drifts across. She's swallowed up by Molly Anderson-Thomas. First defensive test here for Loughborough. Now Sophie Davis. Not a huge amount of gain line being made here by Hartbury, but they're in the right positions. Lucia Scott, another who played in the final last year. Davis again. It's all a bit direct, and Loughborough managing to deal with it defensively. Dale.
I think this is what Loughborough have been prepping for all week. Hartbury, notoriously a very, very physical side, so this week we've been looking at can we get into those spaces and get off the line.
Big clear out coming in there from Veerkamp.
Yeah, Hartbury need to start moving the ball a bit, move the point of contact. They're just going very one up at the moment.
They are going through the phases, they are being patient. And Gemma Bell picks up another carry. Both wingers are holding their edges though, so the options are there, but a little knock on spotted, and Loughborough survive the first assault on their 22.
Yeah, I think that was great defensive pressure from Loughborough. They've done really, really well there, and I think that's just the reward they get from that.
And the reward is a scrum and the opportunity to clear into the wind. They went very much in the favour of Hartbury, and we saw in the men's final earlier on, it was something that Loughborough were able to take advantage of. Morgan Meredith kicking penalties, going for points.
It will be interesting to see how much this this win's worth.
Oof. Well, we're not going to be able to know until the end of the game, are we? However, if you're playing into the wind, oh, that's not a great pass, that's gone forward. Loughborough think they're away, but it'll be brought back.
Yeah, that's unfortunate, but that's really good defence from Hartbury there to put pressure on the nine.
Much better scrum there as well, not giving the penalty away straight away, which is really good from a Loughborough point of view.
Yeah.
What a chance now for Hartbury. It's all well and good wanting to play out of your 22 until you dish up a forward pass.
Yeah, you never like to see that. Never want to be the person given that one.
So Aloe Pierce is packing down at number 8 here for Hartbury. A great campaign for Wales under-18s. Played at lock and played in the back row. Siobhan Lillycrap, former Wales captain in charge of that group. Wonder if she might have a pick and go there, but instead they've gone for the backs, and Scott, fancy footwork, sets the platform, 7 metres short then for Hartbury, currently camped in the Loughborough 22. Slow ball though, so again it's up to crude carriers to try and get over the gain line. Evie Roach. No one around the jackal for Loughborough at the moment. Charlie Maymans can't gather that, but now there could be gaps as Loughborough rush up. Molly Anderson-Thomas, another important tackle. But it's still in red hands. Charlie Maymans to the line. Lovely ball by Charlie Maymans. Lucia Scott feeds Claire Grizzle-Johnson, who doesn't finish. And Loughborough can't drive her into touch. Big line, big shot. Massive tackle on Evie Roach. But now Sophie Davis within a metre. Hartbury as close as they have been. Lucia Scott, Loughborough tackling for their lives. Immense defensive effort. But it's still with Hartbury. Amy Dale coming back for the penalty.
Phenomenal defence by Loughborough there. That last-ditch tackle, absolutely brilliant.
Yeah, Loughborough did really well to save that. Unfortunate for the penalty, but here we've got another see another big defensive set.
See if they go middle in the line out again. Are you getting up, Loughborough, or are you staying down here?
I think at certain points you do get up when you try and put pressure on that, but then it's how quick can you transition to then defending that more.
Amy Dale does go to the middle. Takes her seat at the back of the wall. Still moving forward. Hartbury closing in on the opening score. Closer and closer. Loughborough still just about hanging in there. But eventually they creak. And Hartbury get the first 5-pointer of the final. Amy Dale, a two-time champion, now a try scorer in a Women's National League final. Hartbury 5, Loughborough 0.
Really, really good patience there by the Hartbury Mall. They didn't get going straight away, but they stayed in it and they just kept coming round the corner, shearing round, and then they got the ball over. So really good patience there.
Yeah, I think that's really good patience from Hartbury into doing that. I think Loughborough defended the first stage of it really well, and I think they mauled into the pressure, allowed them to get over the line.
Well, that felt like such a key part of that first half, because 9.5 minutes in, most of them have been in the Loughborough 22 as Charlie Maymans strikes that between the uprights, adds the extras. Hartbury 7, Loughborough 0. And when you spend that amount of time in the 22, you have to get something.
No, completely. And I think that all came from the lack of discipline up further up the field. And I think that's what Loughborough will go into this little bit now after a huddle in the circle and feeling some comms along that. So we'll see what they do here.
It's not the cleanest of strikes for the restart. It's back in Hartbury hands. And here's Allo Pierce for Hartbury. Penalty advantage coming.
Yeah, Hartbury are just going to be playing the territory game here, especially with that win, try and pin Loughborough back. Unfortunately, Loughborough just giving the penalty away there again. Again, gives the Hartbury that kick through, hopefully setting up that driving maul again and just putting them back under that pressure.
Yeah, I completely agree, and I think that this is something that Hartbury have probably gone away and this week and always looked at, and we'll see how they get on with this now.
Yeah, for sure. Hopefully Loughborough going forward will try and cut down that penalty count now to try and keep that possession and that territory.
Yeah, I agree. I think that's something they need to really think about, and something they probably should have comms on in trying to reduce that now.
Speaking of comms on, I've just sent one of the match officials team down to try and get the referee to unmute her microphone.
That always helps.
Amy Dale goes in short. Nice ball off the top for Jess Kershaw to release the back line, or at least the big ball carriers. And there's one of them, Allo Pierce. Loughborough have gone high, so Hartbury have got another penalty advantage to play with. Lovely ball from Lucia Scott to feed the speed. This is glorious from Hartbury. Back into the 22, 5 metres short once again. Banging on the purple door.
Space wide, massive amounts of space wide if they can get the hands free.
Lovely little tip on there, Anouk Veerkamp. Phenomenal this from Hartbury. Just finding ways to pitch themselves in the 22, and Evie Roach has lost that forward. It was a quick turnover before the hands were on the floor.
That's unfortunate from Hartbury there. They did really well to get balls through the hands on the edge on the far side, and I think they did like really well to get as much game line over that. It's just unfortunate there.
So what are you doing here if you're Loughborough? Because you're into the wind, and it's a long kick from under the posts to the touchline as well. Is that the only option?
You could go scrum. But again, last time it didn't go too well, so it's going to be a tricky decision. I'm sure their leaders will be stepping up here.
Yeah, I completely agree. It'd be something that they probably have to discuss around like the wind and that situation before the game, so I'd be interested to see what option they take here.
Well, if they go for the poles, I'll buy you both dinner. How does that sound?
Perfect. Steak, please.
Oh, an early change here for Hartpury, and this not good news is the try scorer Amy Dale, and she's being replaced by Liv Constable, and she's got something clutched to her cheek, so hopefully it's just a blood replacement and she'll be back on, because she will be raring to go after that try. Well, Charlie Maymans is off. Loughborough defending in reverse. They were just about 10 metres there, but Charlie Mayman, so physical in the contact zone, dispatches the defender. Another tip on for Alau Pierce. Certainly doesn't look like she's playing a couple of age groups up, does she? Carrying with venom. It's Bo Westcombe-Evans tackling for Loughborough as Priestnell takes it on now. Grizzle Johnson. That's well taken by Robin Davis. He was down low, managed to get there. Molly Anderson-Thomas needs to roll. That was Hendy in at first receiver. Alau Pierce again. Well, Loughborough turn it over, albeit fortuitously. Westcombe-Evans.
That's really great defensive pressure there from Loughborough to force that knock on, and I think that let's see how they can play out here.
Lucy Weaver.
Yeah, they've got numbers on this right-hand side if they can spread that ball.
It's a good flat ball, carried forward by Fitzpatrick. They've decided to drop it on the toe. It's Grizzle Johnson off her wing. She's kicked that back into midfield. But now it could be on here for Loughborough. Oh, they've kicked it straight away and Charlie Maymans is back there. It's a fast surface, this synthetic turf. At the StoneX. Oh, Kendall Wardby just lost her footing there, but it looked like the turnover was on. It's a first touch for Liv Constable. Played in the Prem Cup on Sunday.
Yeah, she's one of the Hartbury girls who've really stepped up this year, making that change from not just Bucks girl, but also coming into the Gloucester Hartbury squad.
Well, it is a well-trodden pathway, isn't it? More and more we're seeing players make the transition from Women's National League into Premiership Women's Rugby. Loughborough concede with a penalty at the turnover.
I think Universities Rugby is a really great point for that, and I think that the amount of players that we've seen who has played University Rugby that are now within the Prem, within the international side, and I think it's just a really great opportunity for all players.
I definitely think that's one of the advantages of English rugby, is that we have that strength and depth.
Yeah, I completely agree.
Great kick, they're going to be pinning them back again. I'm going to guess driving more.
Yes, I can only agree with that.
Middle?
Centrally.
Well, our commentary position is on the halfway line. Effectively, it's the same as the view that you've got at home. And we have not spent a lot of time looking left in this first half, of which the majority of the game has been played in this area of the pitch, in the Loughborough 22. However, it is just the Amy Dale try and the Charlie Maymans conversion that separate the teams at the moment. Hartbury 7, Loughborough 0. Penalty advantage for Hartbury. Charlie Maymans goes crossfield. There's a lot of space here for Grizzle Johnson, but the bounce of the ball beats them all.
Great idea there. Again, a beautiful maul. Hartbury, what they're doing so well is identifying the corner and shearing round to get that front foot ball off that maul.
Lily, I trust you to be honest with me. So there's a couple of Loughborough players, men's players, who are just coming out of the changing room. You can see Mario Picciardi there as we take a look at this crossfield kick that doesn't quite land on target. These Blazers.
Yes.
Thoughts?
You know what? I actually don't mind them. I think the boys really like them, and I think, to be fair, it does make them look quite smart, and I think they're relatively new as well. But no, I do quite like them.
Okay. Another great line-out by Hartbury. Coming up to 17 minutes. Liv Constable there at the back. Oh, she's grounded it. She's just got it. Liv Constable through a melee of socks and boots to get Hartpury second. Two hookers have played in red. Two have got tries. And it's the set piece that separated the two teams. Hartpury 12, Loughborough nil.
Yeah, I think it's definitely nice to be a hooker when your driving wall's going well, isn't it? Get up on that score sheet.
Yeah, completely agree, especially with, unfortunately, Loughborough's penalty count isn't doing great at the moment. I think for Hartbury, I think if they have got a successful driving wall, obviously they will use that because they've recently been getting the pens from that, and I think that's probably the way they're going to look to go forward.
Charlie Maymans, one from one. Oh, one from two. Good strike. Drifts across the face. 17 minutes gone. Hartbury 12, Loughborough nil.
I think you'll probably see Hartbury here go for the territory again. Collect clean ball and then get rid.
Back underway.
Great initial carry there by Hartbury. Real quick ball, quick ruck.
Ah, a referee. Hello to Rebecca Piddleston. Ref ticked, in fact, she refereed you for England in the 20s against the Army.
Yes, she did.
A couple of weeks ago. Charlie Maymans sends that one to him. Another good strike, using that wind to make it difficult for Baker. Now, Georgina Tasker. What a take by Bo Westcombe-Evans. One-handed scoop behind her, still going Westcombe-Evans. And the first signs of life from this Loughborough attack, but Hartbury straight over the ball. Great turnover, brilliant jackal effort.
That was great work from Georgina there. Lots of footwork, finding into space and then giving that ball to Bo. And I think, unfortunately, there didn't have the players with her quick enough, but I think that was a really good go forward from Loughborough.
Anouk Veerkamp with the turnover.
Yeah, she'll be on a high at the moment. The Dutch team have just qualified for WXV3 in Dubai, so yeah, she's going to be full of energy.
Yeah, super exciting. She had a good Rugby Europe Championship, actually. She got a hat-trick against Sweden. So we'll take another look at this. By Westcombe-Evans break. But yeah, straight over the ball. You could see her almost licking her lips, couldn't you? Like, here we go.
They call that move the chicken wing.
Is it because it's delicious?
Maybe.
Just decided whether or not it'll be Liv Constable to throw this line out in, because Amy Dale has been patched up. She's given the thumbs up, and I think she'll be retaking the field of play shortly. But if you're Liv Constable and you're going to be at the back of another maul here, you're like, leave me on, coach. I'm loving life.
Who doesn't love a driving maul, and who doesn't love a line out?
Oh, who gets locked forwards as co-commentators? Here we go, Hartbury to the ball. Once more, it is Constable on the ball. And they're just marching forward, eating time, eating meters. Sally Williams has lost her footing, so another penalty advantage. Pip Hendy. Left to close the gap, but we'll go back for the penalty. Something you alluded to, Lily, the penalty count really mounting up on Loughborough.
Yeah, and I think Hartbury using that to their advantage. I think with kicking to the court, like kicking to their touchline, Moors, they've got a lot of success from, and unfortunately Loughborough giving away some penalties there, so I think that they're really going to play into that.
Yeah, you can see Hartbury changing it up a bit there, using the maul to get that go forward and then trying to spread it wide. It's just unfortunate that last pass didn't stick.
Yeah, I agree. I think it'd be good to see what Loughborough do now to potentially change the amount of penalties that they're having and what communication they're going to have with each other, and the leaders to step up and try change that.
Yeah, 100%.
So how does it change for Loughborough then? Because, oh, here we are. Hello, everyone. So you play for this team, you know this team, you know the players, you know the coaches. How do they change it? Because we're 20 minutes in here, they're two scores down, so it's not terminal. But unless they start to get some territory, they start to get some possession and ultimately some points, it might be.
Yeah, I think something we worked on this week is our physicality, and I think our go forward, but then also like seeing how far we can play. And I think, yeah, that's something we're going to look at doing, I think. But in this area around here, will be how can we stop that more as quick as possible, and how can we go regain that possession?
Well, this area is the area that the game has been played in largely. We are 20 minutes in. Amy Dale back on the pitch. One try already, and already that Hartbury ball is marching. 20 metres becomes 15 metres. Charlie Maymans in the second receiver this time. Hendy gets the fend away. Hendy still driving the legs. Tasker finishes the tackle off. And Alau Pierce steals another half a metre. It's a hell of a counter there from Georgina Tasker. Fullback putting her head where back rowers belong. Veerkamp. Another strong carry. Amy Dale takes Hartbury to within 2 metres. Now Charlie Maymans steps and tries to weave through. Great balance, beautiful by Charlie Maymans. The offloading game for Hartbury, outstanding. Pip Hendy finds Scott. Scott out to the width. Daisy Aspinall, the England under 18, scores for Hartbury. Beautiful balance from Charlie Maymans, and the handling from then on in, sublime.
Hartbury did really well there, the offload game. I think they kept the ball in play really nicely and got that ball to the edge, and where they've seen lots of success with some really great wingers.
Those feet from Charlie Maymans there made that. It really sucked in those Loughborough defenders, so they had that space out wide. Oh, I think she caught her face a little bit there in the tackle. Let's just hope that nose isn't too sore.
And it's all come off the back of more great line-out work. They're being gifted field position, and they are taking full advantage of those gifts. Another good strike, but too much to ask of the boot of Charlie Maymans. But it is Hartbury 17. Loughborough nil. And one of the question marks about this Hartbury team coming into this is whether or not those players who are still in college, still doing A-levels, still playing under 18 rugby, would be able to cut the mustard at this level, Women's National League level, against players who play Premiership Women's Rugby this season. I think the resounding answer at the moment is yes.
Yes, no, 100%. I think they're really lucky as a programme. They have a lot of experienced coaches coming in to coach them, like the mics of Maudmer, Mohan, and that's what's helping them take that step up.
Sophie Davis takes the restart. It is all Hartbury. There's so much confidence flowing through them. Everyone keen to carry, but Charlie Maymans keen to get rid. Here's Tasker. Likes to run in a broken field. A couple of Hartbury chasers come up. Gemma Bell's the first there, and Tasker weaves her way just shy of halfway. Wally Anderson-Thomas. Now a bit of space for Ellen Scantlebury. Scantlebury, one more pass out. Why, it's a good one. Loughborough into the 22. Sally Williams scores. Where has that come from? Loughborough unleash, and they're on the board.
Oh, that they work that wide so well. That draw and give is so crucial in rugby, to make sure you get that space. And then the pace down the wing was outstanding.
Well, let's take another look at this. The first time we've seen them cut loose.
Yeah, unbelievable feat and speed from Sally Williams there. She's been away with Canada recently, and I think that she's really flourishing in this league. Really, really well worked try from Loughborough.
It's a couple of players with lightning experience. It was Scantlebury who put in Williams. Important conversion. Successful conversion. 7-17. Well, perhaps the game needed that.
Yeah. I think Loughborough deserved that. I think they played really well at those transitions from kicks, and I think that hopefully now they'll get a bit of confidence coming into this bit.
Yeah, it could be a big momentum changer.
Still 15 minutes to go until half-time. Charlie Maymans restart, decides to go deep. Loughborough let it bounce. Decide not to kick immediately. Bo Westcombe-Evans beats the first tackle, gets through clear Grizzle Johnson. A short ball and a big shot on Baverstock. That was Fitzpatrick. And a dart here from Baker. Baker slung around. And then Weaver, lovely take. This much better handling as Izzy Winter carries on this. Williams, she loves being on the edge from the right to the left and still going big fend, and the offload has gone forward. So this will be knock-on advantage to Hartbury.
I think that try brought a great momentum change for Loughborough, and I think there is some great hands, but also the speed of rugby that they're wanting to play is really good.
Hartbury kicked that knock-on advantage away. Tasker eyes at the kick, but she's going to have a maraud instead, and there could be some space here. Fitzpatrick doesn't get the offload away, and I think there are some frustrated players outside it. That was Tasker in at scrum half. Good defensive read by Aspinall. Still with Loughborough, who are totally re-energised after that try. Maisie Johns.
Oh, lovely.
Lovely line, Kendall Wardby.
That was a great line from Kendall. Loughborough frame, some really good tempo here.
Well, Loughborough look a new team. They're still chasing this game though here. Sally Williams, Williams out to Bo Westcombe-Evans. Westcombe-Evans puts the afterburners on, but she swung into touch by Abby Lee Priestnell. What a defensive intervention by the Hartbury centre. Well, it's 17-7. It's kicking off up here. I think it's kicking off down there as well, because Burnsy, have you got Abby Brown with you?
I do have Abby Brown. I haven't just got Abby Brown. I've got a very animated Abby Brown who's been lit alive by that try and this passage from Loughborough.
Yeah, that was outstanding. Like, that's exactly what we can do. We've got ball in hand, but we haven't had the ball in hand for a little while. So actually, now we've got it, then hopefully we can now go put some prize on the board.
Yeah, I mean, rough opening 20 minutes, obviously under the pump, but yeah, just seeing that brilliance that you've got in your locker and sort of seeing the way that you want to be playing.
Yeah, exactly that. Like, we've just been defended for 20 minutes, so and the girls are putting in a shift, but we just come alive when we've got ball in hand.
And you as well. I mean, what's your heart rate like here as a coach?
Yeah, I'm not a good watcher. I don't like being on the sideline, but it's trying to contain it for the girls and bring the energy for them rather than myself.
And, you know, obviously Hartbury, they're looking threatening in attack. You've had a few concessions. What are the things you need to be better around defensively? We can see what you can do with the ball, but, you know, when your back's against the wall, against your line, how should you be shutting them out?
Just being brave with our shots and getting off the line, I think, is key here. Like, we're put under the pump for the first 20 minutes, but, you know, that's the game. And actually, we didn't have the ball. So when we have the ball, we're a lot better with it. Bit more of that, I think.
Bit more of that. And look, let's just talk about the week quickly. You are GB7's captain. You've been on some amazing rides as a player. But how special has it been with this group, with the girls, in the build-up to this historic final?
Oh, it's amazing. I mean, you're in finals time, isn't it? It's the best time. It's the place you want to be at. And I think what is amazing is the group of girls that we've got. They are outstanding. They put everything at it and they train ridiculously hard and so much through the week. So, and even through this whole season, they've worked so hard to be here and massively deserve it. And also they're a real good group of girls. So, yeah.
Exciting times. Okay, I'm going to let you get back to your job. You're itching to get on the pitch and deliver some messages. And I'm going to throw back up to D-Rog and the gang.
Cheers, Burnsy. How good to hear the excitement, the enthusiasm. These are special occasions, and look, for some of these players, they may well go on to have great Premiership women's rugby careers, maybe international careers, maybe, with the growth of the game, British and Irish Lions careers, who knows, but for some of them, this might be the biggest occasion they ever play, might be their final game of rugby ever. It's a phenomenal occasion here at the StoneX Stadium. And at the moment, it's delivering. Hartbury 17, Loughborough 7. Hartbury having to answer some questions for maybe the first time in the match.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how they deal with this pressure now. And they haven't had to deal with it yet, so let's see if they can get a clean exit.
It's another excellent direct carry. And Loughborough have gone a little bit high. And there's nothing quite like a penalty to exit, is there? Sweet relief here for Hartbury.
Yeah, no, she'll be buzzing about that. She's got a lovely boot on her Charlie May Mans as well, so hopefully clear her lines here.
think it'd be good to see a bit more aerial pressure from Loughborough in the lineouts, and I think that they're going to have to compete up there a little bit more.
100%, especially with how dominant they've been in the mall. We've seen that they've gone middle the majority of the time. Can they get up in front of that pod?
Do you remember the rapper Nelly?
The rapper Nelly?
He used to wear a little plaster on his cheek like that, didn't he?
I think Amy Dale will be delighted to be compared to a rapper.
She does not know who Nelly is, and neither does Lily Ives Campion, so please just like Spotify him or something later. He's got some big tunes. Another good line out. Oh, so contact in the air. No, it's not straight.
Oh, I thought she'd given a penalty there.
That's a really good aerial pressure there from Loughborough, and I think that's something they need to go forward.
Called that, didn't you?
Yeah, I did. I did call that one.
The girls heard you.
Must have.
So Agatha Jow is coming into the second row for Hartbury, returning from injury. Semi-final was her first game back from a long-term ankle. What a game to come back into. She's going straight into the engine room here. Well, the set piece certainly going Hartbury's way.
Shame there. They worked so hard in that line out to get that scrum, and then it's just that little bit of detail that's just keeping Hartbury in it, and Loughborough just slightly behind at the moment.
Well, they've opted for the scrum here, which, given how the line-out's been going, is a really interesting decision.
It is. Maybe the front row have said, look, we're feeling it. We think we can get a pen, and actually we can secure that line-out.
This time it's Jess Kershaw. Former teammate of yours at Worcester, right, Jess?
Yes, she was coming through our centre of excellence when I was playing at Worcester. A really bright talent. Unfortunately, had a few concussions, but it's good to see her back now.
Certainly is. Charlie May Manns ships that one on. Lovely ball by Priestnell, and Scott gets it out to the wheels of Aspinall, and they are wheels as well. She's going to back herself around the outside, and that is why Daisy Aspinall, spilled it forward. Fingertips away from an all-time Women's National League classic. And Pip Hendy, has she kicked out there?
We hope not.
Well, either way, it's a put-in at the scrum. It's not been seen, but what about that break from Daisy Aspinall? Confidence of a young flyer.
Oh, she's brilliant. She's done really well over the under-18s period, and I think that her coming into this now, she's going to really flourish within this league.
And credit to Loughborough, that getting back here and even just knocking her off balance, the work from your winger to get back and put that pressure on, outstanding and try-saving.
Now, watch Pip Hendy here. So it's a little bit with Bo Westcombe-Evans. Ooh! And a TMO, look at that. And she might be in a spot of bother. Alas, it's Loughborough who are in a spot of bother. Deep in there, 22 again. Sally Williams gets swallowed up. Good work. Jess Kershaw chops down the number 8. And Loughborough need to find an exit. That's the first tackle of the game for Agatha Jow. And it will be booted clear by Tasker, but it is straight back to Hartbury to come again through Aspel and Lucia Scott. Hendy. Molly Anderson Thomas can't make the tackle without the offload coming. Scott taking it on. Kershaw arrives, tipped on. Evie Roach. Fluid offloading, the kind of offloading that led to try number 3. Charlie Maymans senses a gap and gets the fend away. Charlie Maymans, but the pass sticks. But Loughborough somehow still alive. Zhao. About 8 minutes of the half to go. Anouk Veerkamp, and she loses that collision. But she has taken so many carries, put so much hard work in this first half. Now Manns, Hendy. It's a good tackle by Kerfi. That could have been a mismatch in midfield. Constable, who's back on. Another good ball out to Grizzle Johnson. Back inside to Scott. Hartbury so patient with their phases in the 22. Will it yield another five-pointer? Robin Davis, two within a metre. Discipline so important for both teams, but it's a walk-in for Grizzle Johnson. Patience, perseverance, and points for Hartbury.
You know you're doing well when your hooker can give a flat pass across the line like that.
Well, there's so much to like about this Hartbury team, but the way they don't panic, they're not flustered, they're so composed in the 22.
They're staying really patient, aren't they? I think they've done really well here. Really good pass from Evialli to the edge there.
Yeah, I think they needed that before half-time as well. They've been under the pump a little bit and it's just shown them, and mentally now they'll go, right, we can take the pressure, we can go ahead and score again.
Charlie Mayman, she's been striking the ball well, but it's not been rewarded with points at this stage. She misses that on the near side. Still 5.5 minutes to go until half-time. And Hartbury continue to turn the screw.
Amy Dale's getting a little bit more attention on her than her face. Hopefully she can stay out there with passes like that.
Yeah, I think she definitely needed out there at the moment.
Tasker, this one for Westcombe Evans to chase, but Evie Roach is going to get two safe hands on that. And Charlie Maybans drops it on the toe. And Tasker has another counter attack. Oh, she's popped that right in Scantlebury's chops. However, it was off the head, so no knock on. And Loughborough could steal a few metres instead.
I think you could see Georgina talking to Ellen then. I think there might have been a slight miscommunication.
Baker to the line, Baker, and now Becca Lord. Going back the other way through Wardby. She had that great line earlier. The ball's gone forward. Another chance at the scrum here for Hartbury, a part of the game that's going really well.
Yeah, just unfortunate. Some really nice phases there put together by Loughborough. But yeah, just that little bit of miscommunication, that little bit of detail just costing them again.
Yeah, I think Loughborough do really well actually keeping ball in hands and playing the tempo of the game. I just think it's just unfortunate for that little knock on there.
Set scrum.
Gosh, their legs are going to be tired from all these isometrics.
Well, away come Hartbury, managing to find a kick.
Really great hands from Alex Baker there, keeping hold of that ball.
Bo Westcombe Evans. Then Baker helps it on one more time. Another good line by Johns. Works hard. Curfey.
Loughborough doing really well to keep the ball alive here.
Another 3 minutes to go. Can Loughborough get some more points just before half-time? Well, that's off the feet so they can go, but it's a momentum killer. Or is it? Does it open up here for Wardby? Wardby into the 22. What a fit! What a finish! The right-hand side is Loughborough's friend. And Kendall Wardby joins Sally Williams in scoring absolute screamers.
Hookers are loving today, aren't they? Look at them scoring all over the pitch.
Yeah,
no, it's great to see, and hopefully we can see that injection. We all know how important that score just before half time is, so you can go in and come out again really, really energised.
Well, it looked as though all the momentum had been lost. There was that loose pass, it bounced off the shins, but sometimes that bounce of the ball, it can disrupt the defence. Somebody rushes up and all of a sudden you're disorganised. Wow, Kendall Wardby.
I think it shows Loughborough's resilience as well. It might not always go right, but they're still willing to push through it.
Yeah, I completely agree. I think they've done well there. Like, again, like Lucy Weaver's really pivotal in keeping the tempo of the game really high, and I think she's done really well in that. But again, all the forwards here have been keeping the ball in hand and getting the ball around, so I think really well worth trying for the whole team.
Conversion unsuccessful. It's a 10-point game. Feels like a game that Hartpury should perhaps be further ahead. Cup final rugby does strange things to people. I mean, that kick for starters. Well, Hartpury have been gift wrapped. More field position and maybe the chance to get another score before half time. What a carry that is by Evie Roach. She finds Dale. Hartpury straight back in the Loughborough 22. And another try here would be such a hammer blow after Loughborough have earned the right to still be in the contest at half-time. Lucia Scott, tackled by Molly Anderson-Thomas, who has been phenomenal in defence for Loughborough in this first half.
Yeah, we call that cashing the cheque after you just scored a try. Like, you've got to make sure you retain ball and get that clear quick, because otherwise you put yourself under a whole load of pressure.
Davis, another forward carry from her. Amy Dale tips on Veerkamp. Runs into Lila Kerfey. And out the back they go. That is the half-time bong. Is there another try in it? There is not. It's gone forward. Sweet relief for Loughborough. Bitter disappointment for Claire Grizzle-Johnson. Oh, close, close.
Right idea, unfortunately not quite the execution she wanted.
One thing Hartby are doing really well here is being really physical in this zone, and once they get here, it's actually staying here and seeing coming away with points. I think they've done well to get here and come away with the points they have, and I think that how much can they retain that now?
Well, that was the famous half-time Big Ben bong that they play out here at the StoneX. The pass has gone forward, even from this camera angle we could tell that. The referee, Rebecca Piddleston, who's in a great spot. Oh, Loughborough have missed the hook, and Hartpury have won it against the head. Now, what a chance. Hendy, tackled by Baker. What are Loughborough doing? Daisy Aspinall, she's had a brilliant half. Young England international. Here's Agatha Zhao, 5 metres out. Options both ways. Kershaw, tipped on by Constable. Now Hendy, she finds Priestnell. Great tackle, Bo Westcombe-Evans. And the counter forces the knock on. Superb defence.
That was really good defence from Loughborough there, and I think they've brought so much energy into that, and I think they've done really well to get the knock on from there, just from the effort they've put in.
Well, I think what we've learned here is that the clock in the stadium is not linked in with the referee's watch, because that's twice the ball has gone forward since we believed the clock to be in the red. But they're still out there playing.
Yeah, it might just be because of pauses in play there for injuries.
Well, Loughborough skating on thin ice here. They have to win this scrum. Huge credit to Hartbury for winning that one against the head, though. Oh, they've done it again! This is bonkers! Jess Kershaw straight over the top of her opposite number. Maisie Johns pulls her back a metre. Veerkamp. Still Veerkamp with a penalty advantage. What a crazy end to the half. Liv Constable a metre short for Hartbury. Charlie Maymans looks out wide. Finds the hooker, Amy Dale, over for her second try. The most peculiar end to a half of rugby.
Amy Dale's having an amazing day out there today. She's playing some really great rugby, found herself on the edge a few times, one giving that pass, and this time getting the try for herself.
Yeah, really unfortunate there. Set piece is slightly still letting Loughborough down, but yeah, the number twos are on fire.
Well, they might well be on fire on the score sheet. It's a good finish there, isn't it? She spots the mismatch. It's powerful. Yeah, they might well be on fire on the score sheet, but losing two scrums against the head at the end of a half. Charlie Maymans misses on the other side this time, and that does take us through to half time. And with that second Dale try, if they weren't already, Hartbury certainly fully in control on this scoreboard here at the StoneX, the Women's National League final. As it stands, the three-peat is on. It is Hartbury 27, Loughborough Students 12. Now we're going to have a look at the try lights shortly, but first, let's get your thoughts on the end of the half, because Loughborough defending heroically once, then twice. Of course they conceded the try on the third occasion. You can't lose two scrums against the head at that stage of a game, surely.
No, I think that's a conversation they're going to be having in the change rooms now. It's like, how can they fix up Loughborough's set piece? I think this is usually a really good opportunity for us in a really strong place where we are, but I think now we're going to have a little conversation about that. But also I think conversation needs to happen around discipline. Loughborough's discipline hasn't been that great this half so far, and I think that it's just been a bit unfortunate, but Hartbury have done really well to capitalise on that. So it's, what conversation can we have at half-time to change that this half?
Well, you're in the engine room, you're both second rowers, so I just want to get an opinion from people who've been at the coalface in that scrum. Are there ways that a scrum half can make sure that that doesn't happen? Are there ways that a tight five can make sure that doesn't happen?
Yeah, so what you want is you want really good connection and timing between your nine and your hooker. You practice that in training. You want to get that timing of the feed in. I'm going to be honest as well, how many feeds do you see that are that straight anymore?
Oh.
Use it to your advantage. My dad will kill me for saying that. It's his pet peeve. But you can play it. Get that foot nice and high. But you need your front five keeping that hooker in as well so they can lift their foot.
Well, that half was about far more than those two scrums at the end of it. Let's take a look at some of the best bits. Most of the highlights belonging to Hartbury. This was the first try. Amy Dale, the first try scorer. They'd spent plenty of time in the 22 already, and this was the just reward for a great start.
Yeah, I think we always say set pieces king and queen of rugby, and here it just shows that. It helps you build momentum, and the patience to go around the corner here was absolutely superb.
Yeah, Hartbury had really stayed in that and really drove into the fresh, and I think that was a really good maul from them.
Well, Amy Dale got the first try of the half and the last try of the half as it stands. She had a little bit of a breather as well. She is without bandage there. This was the second. Liv Constable came on. And the ball, a part of the game that's, well, there have been a few differences, mainly on the scoreboard, but certainly in terms of building that score, the ball has been massive for Hartbury.
I think Loughborough needs to find a way as how they can stop that. What can they do to stop that? Is that whether going aerially, line-out-wise, or is that staying down and hitting it? And it's, I think, they're just getting a little bit caught in what to do, and I think they just need to have a good decision in what they're going to do to stop that.
What about this footwork by Charlie Maymans to set up this Daisy Aspinall try?
Yeah, absolutely brilliant. And then the reaction of the Hartbury players around her to actually react to what she was doing and then get that ball to space. It was a real team try, that.
Well, she picked up a bleeding nose as a result, but worth it for the five-pointer. Then Loughborough decided that they were going to announce themselves in the final, and Sally Williams got the first try.
Great speed there from Sally Williams. Like I said earlier, she's been away with Canada, and I think you can really see that she's been away in camp, and I think she's got some really great footwork and one of our most speediest forwards out there, and I think if you give her the ball, she's really well worked and looks like she's going to score.
And then you were talking to us about cashing checks.
So important. This try comes off again, unfortunately. Loughborough weren't securing the ball from their kickoff, and Hartbury again build the pressure. Beautiful pass from Amy Dale across the wing and great finish.
At 22-12, you'd think Loughborough would perhaps have a better chance in this second half, particularly when they know they can score from anything, because Kendall Wardby has made something out of nothing there.
Yeah, she's done really well. She's got some really great footwork into space there and just put her head down and gone. She's, again, another really quick forward, and I think she just looked up and saw the space in front of her and then managed to get going.
And then the self-destruct button straight from the kickoff. We thought the half was over, but Amy Dale had different ideas.
Yeah, she was not done. She wanted to come back on and make up for those minutes she had to go off and get a blood replacement. But really exciting, and I think Loughborough can score from anywhere. And now they've got the wind, so how much of an impact is that going to play?
Well, we'll find out in the second half. Let's get the reaction of the team down there. LJ, who have you got with you?
I've got Amelia Tutt and Jordan Russell with me, ready to talk this one through. And pre-match, they were given it. They're so evenly matched. They're the same side. They both like playing attacking rugby. And is that more or less what we've seen in this first half, Amelia?
Well, as watching, we were saying, whoever is attacking is on the front foot. They are making it challenging. I think when it started off, obviously, with the first try from Hartpury, the 50-22, gorgeous 50-22 from Charlie Maymans, it really set the tone of the game, I think. But when Loughborough got their first try, I think it has shifted the momentum a little bit, hasn't it?
I know that in commentary they've just mentioned that Loughborough have got the wind in the second half. Jordan, do you think that will make a difference?
I think the only thing that will make a difference is which team has possession. I'd argue that for the first half, definitely Hartpury had the ball more, we played more. But as Amelia said, as soon as it shifts, yeah, Loughborough got possession, got that amazing try in the corner by Sally Williams. I do think the wind won't play a huge significant part. I don't think we've seen quite a lot of kicking, apart from obviously that gorgeous 50-22. But I do think it could be a weapon at Arsenal for them to play with, and they can really test our back three, Loughborough, if they decide to actually play in the right areas.
Jordan's mentioned Sally Williams's try there, and we have to talk about it. Yeah. It's not very often that you see a number eight running like that down the wing, untouched by any of the defending players. How impressive is she? That was pretty pacey.
She is a very good player. Also our other try, Kendall, so both forwards play a bit like backs, which I think is a strength of Loughborough. So all of our players are quite versatile. So she is very good. Yeah, one to watch.
Okay, then, if we're going to talk about players who are forwards playing like forwards, we have to talk about Amy Dale. She's had two tries so far, and it always feels like there's more coming from her. She's impossible to stop, yeah, isn't she?
You know what? You can't sleep on Amy Dale. And if we actually cast our minds back to the first ever books final that we played, we actually played Edinburgh at Six Ways. She got three in the bag, and it was very consecutively. It was very one after the other. The good thing with Amy, she's a very consistent player. Like I said, you can't turn off. You've got to, you know, if Amy Dale's in front of you, you've got to have
three girls on her to stop her, I think.
100%.
If we look at Hartbury in this competition, if we look at Gloucester Hartbury in the PWR, in the Prem Cup, they're a side who don't mind conceding tries because they're quite happy to keep scoring. How much is the mantra of Gloucester Hartbury and Hartbury all about just attack, attack, attack?
As much as we take pride in our attack, we take pride in our defence. We love defending. Obviously, I think more so we love attacking. We obviously want to play the rugby, want to show everybody exactly, you know, how hard we play. But we're quite comfortable in defence. I think it's testament to the structure we've got, both for books, it actually is very similarly put in place at Gloss Hartbury. We are very lucky that both the coaching staff for books and for the Prem side is very seamless. We get a lot of time, both with players, both with Sean Lynn, you know, Lewis Arnold. I do think, you know, if we can practice what we preach up top, it will definitely come from the bottom.
And when it comes to Loughborough now, what can they do? Because obviously it's not been about momentum. When they've had the ball in hand, they have scored, yeah, they've managed it, but it's getting hold of it and keeping hold of it. So what will the messages at halftime be?
If I was to give the messages, it would be to slow it down. They need to slow it down a bit. Each time they get the ball, which is often from any mistake that Hartbury makes, they jump on that, they get the ball, they're just chucking it away a little bit. They need to slow it down, stick to what they're good at, and get it to the edge.
And how do Hartbury maintain what we've seen so far in this first half? Because complacency can set in a final like this. That, you know, those girls are going to have one eye on those medals. They know they're coming. They're going to be hanging around their necks in 40 minutes if they keep on going like this.
I think they shouldn't even think like that. I think it should go back to 0-0 at halftime. That's how I would, if I was doing that team talk at halftime. I do think, though, you know, Loughborough will come back into the game. We've talked a lot about that shift in momentum. I think if anything, the girls were really fired up at half time to come and give us like almost a new 40 minutes. And for these girls, they just can't, you know, got to keep the foot on the throttle.
Yeah. So instead of asking you how each of your teams can win this, I'm going to swap it around. So Jordan, I want to know, If you were playing for Loughborough, how'd you beat Hartbury in the second half of this game?
I'd do what Amelia said. I'd slow the breakdown down. That's what's killing us. You know, if they have quick breakdown, it's averaging it. Look, it's looking about 2 seconds. If I can slow the breakdown down, we can correct our fold. We can get numbers on. And instead of us trying to play like a drift defence, we've got numbers on. We can actually go and get, you know, we can really get in their faces. We can get really hot line speed. And then from there, then we can put the pressure on at ruck time and hopefully force an error, force a mistake.
And Amelia, if you were playing for Hartbury, how would you keep your foot on the throat of Loughborough at this point?
Well, I think as soon as they're getting into their try zone, they're pretty unstoppable. I mean, Loughborough are doing really well, phase after phase, defence to stop them. But I think as soon as they get into that field, they've got it in the bag, really. But
it's a huge evening here at the StoneX, isn't it? We are at a stadium that's become very famous for European rugby over the years and PWR victories. And how special is it for the girls to be playing a game like this here on an occasion like this evening?
I mean, it's crazy. I mean, for Loughborough especially, they haven't won in many years, so it would be incredible. I know I'm friends with the girls that they would love it. It would be huge for them.
Jordan?
I think it's just about sharing experience. Like, I was lucky that we did this last year. You know, like, I speak about it all the time, you know, how I still would love to be in Bucks. For me, if the girls can actually get another experience like this, it will, you know, will cement in their lives for five to come, hopefully for all their rugby career.
Yeah.
Well, I think let's throw back up to the girls and Dave Rogers in comms for a sparkling second half, the Women's National League final. We want 40 minutes until we find out who our champions are.
Thanks, LJ. Sparkling would be lovely, wouldn't it? Particularly under the lights here at the home of Saracens, looking up into the stands and seeing the pink and African violet flags waving. But at the moment, most of the joy belonging to Hartbury. 27-12. 15 points, the points barrier that they need to overcome. It's a three-score game, Lily. Need to get the first try. It's as simple as that, isn't it?
Yeah, and I think they would have had some really great conversations at halftime, so it's how can they capitalise on that now coming into this half?
Who leads the chats at halftime?
So we've got some really key players like Ellen, along with Georgina. Some really, like, really key players in terms of chats. A lot of attacking chats going on there, but also Georgina will lead on defensive as well.
Second half underway. Charlie Maymans kicked so well in the first half to put Hartbury in the right spots. That's ushered towards touch by Daisy Aspinall. A lot of maturity about her for an 18-year-old, isn't there?
Yeah, she's showing a lot of promise. Like there, for example, she didn't go for the ball. She knew where she was in a space and she allowed it to go out so they can retain possession. Really, really mature.
Amy Dale on a hat-trick. More good line-up ball for Kershaw to find Charlie Maymans. And now big ball carriers there in midfield again. This has been the shape that Hartbury have liked to play, and it's the shape that has taken them to a 15-point lead. That was Robin Davis in the scrum half. Is that knocked on? Liv Constable's gone down clutching her face after that.
Yeah, I think she just got caught there when she was trying to dive on the ball, which is never good to see.
I think there's also been a change for Loughborough at half time.
Yes, we've got Steph Atkinson on in the front row. Who else have you spotted?
I think she's come on for Maisie Johns. I think.
So what will that mean for the reshuffle then? Because Steph Atkinson is a prop by trade.
Potentially Kath Babb will go to the second row. Back row.
Utility player, love those.
Yeah, she's great.
You've got to be a full court footballer these days though, haven't you?
Don't give Kath Babb the ball, she will kick it.
Well, funnily enough, I had a lovely chat to Katie Trefarthen before today, and she said that she's been put on a kicking ban.
Yes, so at training she's really good at it. She gets the ball and a lot of the time she does kick, but sometimes it's not the best option.
Well, I think we should see more forwards kicking. I think it's a great part of the game.
Well, she is a former back rower who's been encouraged to become a loose head prop by Katie Trevathan. But to be fair, who better to learn off? I'm just going to help you get your coat on here, because of course you are currently in a cast. We have to explain your presence here, actually, Lily, because originally I thought you'd be playing in the semi-final, but then you were called into the England camp, so there are best part of a dozen players missing from the Hartbury team, half a dozen missing from Loughborough. We were expecting you to be one of them, but as we can see on camera, you're in a sling, so on the field's loss is off the field's gain, because you keep us company for this one. But tell us what's happened.
Yeah, just had a little knock in training on my finger last week. Just something like just had to look at, been for a couple scans, but I have broken my finger, which just seems like a lot for a broken finger. But yeah, just in that management stage of it right now. But really gutted to not be here with the to either be here at the final day or down with the 20s girls this weekend. But I think again, two really good squads have come out. But I'm glad I can be here at the final today.
So you have been into the 20s camp then. Tell us about the group. Tell us about the expectation, because it's a massive opportunity.
Really massive game. The game against France is always a massive game for us, and we've got a really great squad and a really strong squad is what I would say. We've got some really great backs out there with, you know, Hartbury missing the likes of Millie Hyatt today, who's a really big player for her. And we've got Leah Green, who's been at Loughborough, who's with the 20s girls this weekend. And I think both teams have lost some of their 20s girls, but I think still what a great match it is today.
Oh, it certainly is.
I think that demonstrates the depth, doesn't it? That you can have these incredible 20s and premiership players, because they're all breaking into the Prem now as well, but you've got those youngsters coming through. And I think that's credit to the academy system, the centre of excellence, and actually this growth of the game.
Yeah, I completely agree. And that's all within this league as well. A lot of the players in our 20 squad at the moment do play Bucks rugby. And I think that this league just shows how important it is, especially to achieve on that international level.
What of the French then? Because we've just had the under-18s Six Nations Festival. That was in North Wales at Stadium CSM. England did very well. In fact, all the home nations had obvious qualities, but France were absolutely outstanding.
Yeah, I've been lucky enough to play France under-20s before. I've played them over the last 2 years, actually. I played them home and away. And what a match they always bring. Very physical team, very direct team. Offload game is always brilliant. But yeah, it's going to be a really interesting match this weekend. I think we've got a really strong squad, one of the strongest squads I've seen, with some really amazing players. And I think that it's going to be great to see the game this weekend, 100%. I think that France, again, like I said, bring a lot of that physicality. But I think actually the occasion itself is massive for us. And France are really good with the stadium that we've put up in and the amount of expectations we've come to watch. Just the atmosphere is insane.
Well, what about that Army game that you played in as well? In fact, our pal Joe Burns was on commentary for that when he said it was a fantastic occasion. He was really impressed with what we saw. Of course, the Inter-Services Championships, men's and women's, taking place very soon as well. How was that experience, the chance to wear the red rose again?
Oh, that was brilliant. And to captain those girls out there as well was an absolute great game. Like, we've had quite a few training camps up before that, but obviously no games. That was our first game out, so apprehensive of how it was going to go. But we came out and we worked together really well. And I think we have such an amazing group. We have our 10, 12, 13 combo at the moment. It's ridiculous. It's really great talent out there. But I think, again, like as forwards, we were really strong working together. And it was really good to implement what we've been doing off the pitch, actually on the pitch. And yeah, it's been going really well. So massive good luck to those girls this weekend. And I will be watching from home.
I can't believe they sent you home. I thought you might at least be able to go out and be
part of it. I didn't go in the first place.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
No. I didn't go in the first place.
I always feel as though that's incredibly harsh when someone gets selected for a tour in any sport, then they get injured, and instead of being able to be out with their teammates, they send them home. However, I'm sure they have their reason. So the reason for this game currently not taking place is we have got an injury delay, but there is movement out there, and movement is usually good, so hopefully these are all precautionary measures. Let's take another look at the tries then, because there were six of them in that first half.
Again,
in fact, there were seven of them, sorry.
Oh, seven.
And this was the first. This was the Amy Dale opener.
yet again, really set this maul. And you can see there, Loughborough just come off on the left-hand side of that maul, and that enables that spin. And then the patience to then go over the line was brilliant by Hartbury.
Charlie Maybans with one of the most casual celebrations of a try there.
She's a chilled person.
Certainly is. She has plenty of contributions, but didn't make one to that particular score. Amy Dale, of course, looking for a third consecutive Women's National League title. It wasn't her for the next one. It was Liv Constable.
Yeah, she'll be really happy with that try. And I'm glad she's got it, especially now she's injured, bless her. So she can still take something away from this.
So that made it 12-0, one successful conversion from Charlie Maymans. And this certainly aesthetically, perhaps the pick of the bunch, beautiful dancing feet, but just getting the ball out of contact. That first offload there by Alo Pierce, unbelievable.
Yeah, it was a really, really well-worked try there. The feet from Charlie Maymans, the offloads, managing to get your hands free and get the ball away, it was really good for Hartbury there.
Then it was Loughborough's turn. It was a couple of the experienced campaigners with Premiership Women's Rugby experience. First Scantlebury, then Sally Williams.
Yeah, really well worked try there for Sally. Absolute crazy speed there on the edge and the ability with her footwork to get there and then to get over with that try.
Some celebration too, but Hartbury didn't take long to get back into it. Robin Davis, another really direct carry. And you alluded to it, that ball from Amy Dale to find Grizzle Johnson.
Yeah, it's so exciting that nowadays you don't just have forwards and backs, you've got 15 rugby players, and actually forwards are expected to have exactly the same skill set as backs.
Speaking of forwards with skill sets of backs, we've got Wardby here. Just as we thought this attack was about to peter out, lovely technique, getting the ball in the right hand, fending both Scott and Grizzle Johnson.
Yeah, that was great work from Kendall there. She had support on the outside there with Scantlebury, but she took it for herself with a great fend and footwork and powerful over the line.
But then the most bonkers end. I mean, we see the try there, but it bears repeating. Loughborough defended their 22 heroically, having coughed up possession and then lost not one, but two scrums against the head.
Yeah, it's those little errors and those little things start to add up at this stage in finals. And they've just got to be really conscious of that. I know, Lily, you alluded it to in the first half, that discipline. And hopefully we see this in the second half once we get back going, that would have been changed a little bit.
Well, those things do add up. But at the moment, they've added up to Hartbury's 27 points and Loughborough's 12. Sniff Constable down there, getting medical attention. The stretcher's out there. She was kicking her toes and moving her feet before. Certainly not going to speculate on the injury, but whatever it is, we wish her well. Hope that she's back fighting fit in no time at all. And these disruptions really can have an impact on the game, can't they? They can have an impact on players' mind states, particularly for those teammates of the player who's been affected.
Yeah, completely. I think that it's a momentum loss of the game, and with the game stopping, and teams can have to really rebuild what they've been working. And but also with the weather today, like, it's quite cold here.
Yes.
And I think so, for both teams to just stop and then having to get re-warm again, it's going to be quite hard then to get back into the game.
Well, we're just about a minute into the second half. It's pretty good signage there, actually.
Yeah, they are, aren't they?
Yeah.
You know what? I've never had a sign made for me.
Have you not?
I think my friends need to step it up.
No, I haven't either, but I think I would love one.
Well, that one there is for Sophie Davis, her last game for Hartbury. Well, let's have a talk about that then, because on both sides of the ball, there are players who will be wearing this jersey for the last time. Of course, the same can be said of the semi-finalists, the quarter-finalists, those in the league who didn't make the knockouts. And whether it's a happy end or a sad end when the whistle goes, I'd imagine everybody will be leaving. Oh my goodness me, look at those lightning hats and the flags. I'd imagine everyone will be leaving with such fond memories of their time at Loughborough or Hartbury, both great rugby institutions.
Yeah, that's the thing about this league, the University League. Obviously, every 3 years players come in and they come out and they leave the league. But I think that the league this year itself has been really competitive for all teams, like you've seen. But yeah, I think it's just a great opportunity for everyone involved.
And you always look, I remember my uni days, you always look so fondly back on that time. And whether you win or lose, it's the command, like the teamwork, and it's just such a beautiful atmosphere in the league.
It's some of the best fun you'll have, but also some of your best friends, I think. That's what comes from university rugby. You play in rugby week in, week out with your housemates, with people you like, some of your best friends. So, yeah.
It's a bit different when you go up to a different level, isn't it? So it's nice to remember those times.
Well, we wish the very, very best in recovery. Not the way we like to see anybody leaving the field of play, but the warmest of applause from teammates, opponents, and everyone here inside the StoneX Stadium. We'll reset with the scrum. Freya McGinley has come on as a replacement for Hartpury. One thing we've not spoken about is Hartpury have gone 6-2. But it might be a 7-1 because Kelsey Webster could play in the centres and in the back row. So Tilly Ryle is the only out-and-out back named on the bench for Hartbury, a.k.a. the Springboks. We'll get back underway. 90 seconds of the second half gone. Loughborough with a put-in at the scrum after the knock-on. But that scrum finds its target. Much better from Loughborough. Baker in it. First receiver, getting it out to that edge quickly, and Bo Westcombe-Evans, and Westcombe-Evans thoroughly enjoys galloping into space. Tipped on well, it's a really good tackle by Kershaw on Finch. Scrum half on back row. Oh, another injury, it's Scott this time. She looks in real discomfort.
I think that was a really much better scrum there from Loughborough. Really gained possession well, and Bo gave really good front football for us and then played into the tempo nicely.
Yeah, they came back from that break with some real energy there, which is really good. And unfortunately, this is what can sometimes happen when you've stopped for a minute. Unfortunately, the body can, as you said earlier, cool down a bit, and you're more prone for those knocks to hurt a bit more.
Well, synthetic surfaces are more and more popular, more and more common across all levels of rugby now, but you've both played on this one in particular. What does it play like?
Quick.
Yeah, I really like it here.
Yeah. Just fast up.
Yeah.
Vaseline on the elbows and knees. Stops the burns.
Top tips. And we appreciate them. Oh, this is bad news. We don't like to see this. This is Lucia Scott. I mean, she has got plenty more gas in the tank. Just a second year student. She's another one. She's doubled up. She played Prem Cup on Sunday. She's really well thought of. We were actually talking at half time about her having a massive future. What a talent.
Yeah, and she's so young. So young. And that's what's so exciting about seeing these players coming through, is they're getting this exposure to such incredible performance, lifestyle, training at such a young age that I wish I had. And I know other players do as well. And it just pushes them on to hopefully reach their potential.
Well, I talked about my conversation with Katie Trevathan. Talked to Andrew Ford as well. And he was saying that their objective initially with Hartbury was to get as many players as they could into the Gloucester Hartbury setup or into the England or Wales or whatever setup. But now it's getting as many women remaining in rugby as possible, because, you know, there was the stage where the Premier 15s was the be-all and end-all, and if you weren't there, it was really difficult. But now it's important to have... Oh, my goodness, they've just put Abba on. Really ruined the important point I was making about rugby. No, really important to have a thriving league outside of Premiership Women's Rugby. It's really important to have a thriving university league and college league and schools leagues. And that's what we're getting now, isn't it? People who are playing rugby, enjoying rugby outside of the very top level.
Yeah, completely. Hartbury and Loughborough are quite similar in the fact that they have Loughborough College, Hartford College, who are in that college league, and then University Bucks League, and then obviously Premiership side. So I think both pathways themselves are built quite similarly.
Yeah, and you've got the Championship as well, which is just going up and up.
Well, it was interesting this year at the Roslyn Park Sevens. It was the first year where Hartbury didn't make the final, and I'm sure that they were absolutely gutted, but in terms of growth of the game, that's good news. Into the 22 we go. The penalty was to Loughborough. They've got the chance to build. Ooh, the sketchy ball, but it's come out Loughborough's way. Lovely inside ball. Second touch for Baverstock. Fabulous handling. Molly Anderson-Thomas brought down a couple of metres short. Trying to free the hands is Isla Kerfey. And head down by Sally Williams. Not as much space as she found earlier on the edge. That is Baverstock. Need some quick ball here, Loughborough. Weaver gets swallowed up, and that's been gathered by Baker. It was a bouncing ball. Got it on the half volley, so Tasker fills in at nine. Back against the grain is Wardby. As Loughborough set, they're a long way out for these picks. Penalty advantage for the high tackle. Called quickly by Piddleston.
I wasn't sure if they were going to go for the tap then.
I thought they were. But this is exactly what Loughborough want. This is exactly how they wanted to start this half, with that energy. Oh, they are going
to go for the tap. Head down into the contact zone, 2 metres short. Back the other way goes Wardby. Oh, it's a good tackle on her at the end. But now just a metre to go for Loughborough. A good pick, a great tackle. And Hartbury winning that physicality. Another grab, another go. That post protector being ruffled, but at the moment the whitewash not being bothered. It's a good latch, but more good defence. Now Weaver has a look. How wide it goes, but it's knocked on by Bo Westcombe-Evans. The ball had gone forward as well, and that is a gilt-edged opportunity for Loughborough wasted.
I wonder if they went the right way there. If nine scooted to the right, they had a 3-on-1. So,
yeah, all the forwards were really, really tight around that breakdown. So, potentially just have a little scan there at the base of which is the right way to go.
But incredibly positive, like really, really good start to the second half for Loughborough.
Yeah, completely. They've come out, complete momentum switch, and you can see they're really playing some direct rugby here.
Kelsey Webster has come on. And that ruins the 7-1 idea because she's come on into the back line. But she's another player. She's at Hartbury College, but has played the whole season with the Bucks team. Celtic Challenge.
Another league that is really, helping women's rugby.
Absolutely. She was invited to train with Wales seniors as well. Hartbury with a bit of a deal of that scrum. That's not a great clearance from Charlie Maymans.
That was a really good pressure there from Loughborough in the scrum. Forcing an opportunity 10, 15 metres out.
You can feel it building now, can't you? You can really feel that pressure building.
Still no score in the second half. Kendall Wardby, one try already. If she manages to get one from the ball here, it'll be very different to her first, but it's a good line out. Loughborough start to go forward. Wardby picks it up at the back. See it there, tucked under the right arm. Weaver wants to get her hands on it. It's well buffeted by Hartbury. Oh, they're going to need to roll there, surely. Yeah, Evie Roach just lying all over the ball. Quite cynically at the end too.
Hartbury have to be careful here. This is a couple of penalties they've now given in that red zone.
Oh, well, it'd be interesting to see what Loughborough try do here. Mm-hmm. I think they'll go for the corner.
Well, she's lying on that ball because she thought it was a ball and she thought it would be turned over and they'd have the put in at the scrum, but the referee hadn't called it. So she's just cynically lying in an offside position, probably lucky not to go to the bin.
100%.
Tap and go for Loughborough, ignoring the opportunity for the line out. And oh, they're over! What a score! Isla Kerfey has gone over straight from the tap!
It's a really great physicality there from Isla.
Yeah, I just don't think Hartbury were quite expecting that leg drive on that carry.
You can see her, she put her head down, went straight over.
Love to see it, love to see it. Now we've got a game on our hands, eh?
Yes, we
really do.
Do. Well, there's always a slight raise of the eyebrows from there when a team with a good set piece ignores the chance to go for the touchline. But it's vindicated. It's 5 points on the board.
Sometimes the biggest thing there is just backing yourself.
Flags stay down, but it's great news for Loughborough. They're back in the game, but bad news Lucha Scott down there, because she's got a pair of crutches and a right leg that isn't touching the floor. Well, let's take another look at this.
Yeah, Loughborough's obviously working around this and training this week, and I think the physicality there from Isla to get under that and then to keep that leg drive going was great.
Phenomenal latch as well.
Jess Kershaw latching on that ball too, Molly Anderson-Thomas.
Loughborough have really come out here with a lot of momentum.
Scantlebury tiptoeing up the touchline. Good cover, Kelsey Webster. That's her first contribution to this game, and it's a good one.
This is good from Loughborough, coming out here with a lot of momentum.
Yeah, they've really sped up that breakdown, which I think is really catching Hartbury on that back foot and enabling that those gain line carries.
Yeah, I completely agree. I think Lucy Weaver herself, is the way she plays at nine, she loves tempo. She's really good at picking up those balls to play fast.
Are they going to get up here?
Amy Dale, you're thinking about it. Oh, that was on the edge of straight. Referee Rebecca Piddleston a lot closer than this. Brilliant balling from Hartbury. Brilliant morning from Hartbury, still going. That's 15 metres they've made from inside their own half to over the 10. And when it goes to ground, Kershaw can get him going again. Charlie Maymans has swapped with Priestnell. This time it's Hartbury who want to find the edge, but Webster straightens up. She is quite the gain line merchant when she gets going. Oof, Fitzpatrick needs to be careful. Wind has picked up down there a little bit. It's bitingly cold as well for the time of year. Great scramble. Aggressive carry. Zhao. Charlie Maymans finds herself in the hands of Webster. She's going to back herself this time. Oh, it's Scantlebury. Gets one back. So they're one each over there on the touchline.
Yeah, I think that was some really great D there from Loughborough. Yeah, worked really well together on the inside and outside to get that.
They were getting those double hits, they were slowing that ruck down, and they were really getting off the line. So, yeah, 100% agree.
Is Freya Green-Smith coming on here for Loughborough?
I always love the funky K-tape some people wear.
What's it do?
I don't know. I think it's just for comfort and style, to be honest.
Smith on, former centre of excellence at Loughborough. Flat ball and another good carry. That's Lord, the outside centre. Both teams making hay at the middle of the park. It's well picked up. Wardby again. She's been outstanding. Loughborough start to build, but running more towards traffic than away from traffic. That one's taken well in the slips by Baker. And it is totally cluttered in the middle of the park, and it comes up red through Gemma Bell.
That ball's out.
Short ball by Evie Roach. Hole punched through, and the offload, superb. So much better from Hartbury. Maybe Loughborough have shocked them into life. It's all gone very narrow. Ooh, has that been knocked on off a hand or a foot? A hand? So, but if this whistle's going, is there going to be any further action? There's no one at home for Loughborough. And are they back 10? Either way, Hartbury into the 22 through Priestnell. Sally Williams thought she turned it over. Referee has other ideas. and an advantage here, Amy Dale. Oh, a double blast on the whistle. This is usually bad news.
Yeah, I'm not sure if they were 10 on that penalty.
Captain!
Let's listen in.
Captain! What I need to see for a better picture is ball and lift only for a reward.
Yeah, so the referees are saying that they're not quite lifting that ball on the jackal, and so that's why she's pinging them.
Well, seeing the replay there, I think she's quite hard done by.
Yeah, I can agree there.
Thirdly agree.
It's just a bit of rain coming down here now, actually.
Just to add some more things to the mix.
Great opportunity here for Hartbury to get back out into that 15-point lead that they carried into the break.
Anouk is enjoying that rain there.
But Jess Kershaw is down for Hartbury. They do have scrum half cover in the shape of Tilly Ryle.
It's a shame, she's been playing really well for Hartbury this game. Really giving quick ball, but again, as a nine, she really offers a good defensive structure as well.
Yeah, she's been absolutely dishing it up to back rowers, hasn't she? Here we go then. Amy Dale finds Robin Davis, but it's been knocked on at the back. Oh, let off for Loughborough.
That's a very uncharacteristic error there. Finals get to people.
Yeah. That's a fun bit of captaincy we picked up on the referee's mic there. What was that for? Was it the not straight or the knock on? Just asking the questions.
That's being a good captain there. Get in the mind, get in the head of the referee.
Crouch!
Great news for Hartbury. Jess Kershaw back on her feet. Plenty of tape on that right peg. Better feed from Weaver, better pressure from Hartbury. Oh, but the advantage goes to Loughborough.
I think that might be for Wheeling.
Yeah, I think that.
Fitzpatrick, strong carry. Loughborough still inside their 22. And now chance to gallop into space. Big chasing coming, but Loughborough with bags of gas. And a first carry for Freya Greensmith is a successful one. Quick one at the short side. Scantlebury. Oh, she's put a foot into touch. And some afters. I tell you what, that Scantlebury Webster contest on this near side. Keep your eye on that.
Yeah, it's getting a bit feisty, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Kind of love that, though. That's what finals are about, no?
Freya McCall coming on. The first year student, she's been called into the Scotland Under-20s camp. This is her first game back since November, where she fractured a tib against Cardiff.
Wow, that's not a nice injury, that one.
No, but huge faith from Katie and Co to say that she can step back in.
Minimal, I'm not sure, but minimal. They're closer than we are.
Another strong ball from Hartbury, leading by 10, approaching 15 minutes of the second half. But don't quote us on that, because there was a rather lengthy injury delay. So let's hope we get as much of this brilliant game as possible, and it has been a brilliant game too. Loose pass finds its way to Webster. Webster backs herself and then finds Aspinall.
Hartbury were just really, really deep there, and I think that's why that disconnect happened between 10 and Pip there, just because they were so far back.
I think Lapa have a really good opportunity here to get some front foot ball going. A few changes on, a few fresh legs, and we'll see how that works for them.
That's overthrown and it's gone to the back. It's back with Hartpury.
Gemma Bell's getting through some work, isn't she, in this game? Some really, really big carries.
Well, they're on an advantage here as well. Hartbury, Daisy Aspinall. Steps back inside. There are a few gaps in this Loughborough defence, but she manages to find a right shoulder in the end. Again, this super narrow. No one on this left-hand side at the moment, Hartbury.
It's a really great line speed here from Loughborough.
That's Freya Gidley, who's come on, another college student for Hartbury. Well taken, awkward bouncing ball and a stop and a go, and Tasker.
So hard to take those balls because you can't see them cleanly, so it's a real skill.
Fitzpatrick straightens up. Good ruck speed this for Loughborough to work with. Drawing the player and releasing Greensmith. Well, that was a big commitment looking for the jackal there for Hartbury. Bit more intensity about this, and credit to Keevy Fitzpatrick. She has been everywhere.
She's been doing well, hasn't she?
Nice short ball. That brings Lucy Finch into the game. The inside ball, the line by Tasker. Tasker in behind. What a tackle again by Kershaw. And Loughborough need to clean up. Hartbury asking questions at the breakdown.
That's a really good option there for Loughborough.
Isla, try scorer, stood up. Oh, Jess Kershaw stayed down again, gets gingerly to her feet. That inside ball working for Loughborough. And Tasker, Georgina Tasker for Loughborough. One defender to beat, last-ditch tackle by Aspinall's a good one. But now Loughborough need to keep their composure. Oh, wow! Priestnell knocked on. Referee saying just a knock on. She went for it with two hands. Well, Abby Lee Priestnell goes at it with two hands. If she catches that, maybe it's the full length. And now Loughborough, an absolute brain melt, have conceded a penalty by chatting back to Rebecca Piddleston.
You can't do that, you can't do that anymore. The referees are so strict on it, and rightly so. You need to respect the decision that's being made.
Yeah, well, it was a great effort by Abby Lee Priestnell. But that is not... Oh, it didn't look like Charlie Maymans had got there. Just beat Lawn to it.
It's a really great go for and a good moment there from Loughborough. Those inside balls of Georgina Tasker. I think she's played outstanding so far. And, yeah, it'd be really great to see what happens in the rest of this. It's unfortunate there. A little bit of back chat to the ref. Just say, like, it's the things you really need to do.
And my response was she's gone with two hands, and therefore I don't feel it's deliberate. That's my option for the scrum option, which is what I said clearly, and you can see the action.
Yeah, just clarifying there that it was the back chat that made that a turnover.
As you say, finals rugby does strange things to people. And that is the race round of Jess Kershaw. She's limping off. She's had a brilliant game at scrum half for Hartbury.
Yeah, she really has. She's brought some really great tempo there to that team.
So she'll be replaced by Tilly Ryle.
This is, again, another really good maul from Hartbury.
Well, it's good line speed, but it's a missed tackle on Priestnell. Charlie Maymans. Oh, smart nudging behind. And another nudge in behind as well. Loughborough chasing back. Pip Hendy.
Did she tackle her without the ball there?
Either way, Scantlebury has decided she's got an iron grip on the fend. Well, this game being played at breakneck pace now. There are going to be some tired bodies out there. He did say that this surface plays particularly quickly. Oh, good tackle, Amy Dale. Monster collision, but great tempo from Loughborough. Scantlebury. Well, that ball has found its way to Baverstock.
She's done well there to keep the ball alive.
Steph Atkinson, wearing 18. Good line speed as well from Hartbury, led by Pip Handy. The referee did ask her to leave. And Loughborough are away. Weaver wants to keep going, wants to keep playing. So does Tasker. Tasker finds McCall. McCall into the 22. Great bend by McCall. She goes to ground. Loughborough back in the 22. An hour gone. And now it slows down. Hartbury can reset the defence. Sally Williams latching on. No opportunity to put her into space in this second half. No, Ward B latches. Oh, that's speaking of brain fades. A Nuke Veerkamp.
Cynical. It's hard.
60 minutes gone. Anouk Veerkamp sent to the bin.
I think that just comes from this added pressure from the Loughborough team, and they've gone quick again, more pressure.
Well, they just want to play, don't they? They just want to wear Hartbury out, but they need points on the board, and if they can get them quickly in this sin bin period, then that could well turn this game on its head. This is a massive, massive phase of this game. Wardby, is that high from Davis? Referee says no. Atkinson goes. She's a little bit high. She's brought to ground by Dale. Sally Williams, next cab off the rank. Get Williams up high, wrestled to the ground by Davis. Great defence. Lucy Weaver barking instructions, so it's Fitzpatrick who takes it on. All part of the forwards right now. They're queuing up. It has to go left for Loughborough, but they go narrow again. So many numbers. Now it goes to the left, but it's been knocked off by Baker. Oh, how many chances do Loughborough want?
That's unfortunate.
Oh, goodness gracious me. Yeah, it was on a plate for them there, unfortunately, but they just didn't get the comms into nine, or they didn't see it in time.
Well, 18 minutes to go. Hartbury down to 14. It's still Hartbury 27, Loughborough 17. That's the yellow card incident. Anouk Veerkamp, well, she thought the ball was out. Your thoughts?
I just think in this area here, you've just got to play a bit safer. I think that Hartbury doing really well, some really great tackles, pushing Loughborough back. And I think that just probably is a decision that probably didn't need to happen because they were doing really well anyway.
100% agree. One thing that I've been so impressed with Loughborough, from this middle part of the field, the work rate from every single individual, whether a back or a prop, to get to that ruck and secure the ball has been absolutely fantastic. And that's what has enabled them to get into that 22.
Well, there was another incident inside the 22 as well. Abby Lee Priest, that was the knock on there. I mean, Alex Baker. But the other incident, the knock on by Abby Lee Priestnell, that the referee said was just a knock-on, and Loughborough talking their way out of an attacking scrum into a defensive penalty. That is a huge swing, isn't it?
Yeah, it is, completely.
I think it'll be a big learning curve, that. And that sometimes you've got to be in these situations to learn from them to then move forward.
Well, the coaches down there, you've got Hannah DeRoland, Katie Trevathan, Nathan Smith, and then Andrew Ford. He's had a fresh fade for the cameras. Tell you all. Oh, Loughborough going early. Well, you talked about first half discipline, Lily. It's costing them again here.
Yeah, that's just unfortunate, and I think that they've really given Hartbury here an opportunity to get back into the game, and it'll be interesting to see what happens now.
And interestingly, Charlie Maybans has put that straight into touch. Off a free kick, and invited Loughborough to have another go.
They obviously back their line out deep. That's what I'd say there.
Well, it's still a two-score game, but what a game it is. Well, judging by those shapes, as Alicia Smith, another college student, has come on We're at number 17 for Hartpury. Oh, there's a touch on it. I think that might have gone forward off Hartbury, but it's with Loughborough. And Becca Lawn. And spilt forward. And a knock-on advantage for Hartbury. Well, the advantage is over. They're back where they started. But are they going to try and run it here, Hartbury? Oh, it's been knocked on! Coughed up for Loughborough.
Oh, was she in front of the player when she picked that up? Is that not a penalty?
But Katie Harrison coming on, a hooker transitioning to back row.
Great platform here for Loughborough. Midfield scrum, that is a back's dream, especially with a man up. Or woman up, sorry. Person up.
Well, they've got four to the left of the scrum, two to the right. It's Freya McColl and Amelia Greensmith to the right.
Set, two, three.
Alex Baker waiting at first receiver to the left. In it comes from Weaver. What a scrum from Hartbury! But it comes out of the back. Williams tidies that up brilliantly. It's Hartbury had poured all the pressure on. Carried by Finch. Makes meters. Here comes Weaver. Checks where everyone is. Of course, Fitzpatrick is the first to offer herself. Now Williams. Oh, Williams has met really well. That was Charlie Raymond's, wasn't it? What a tackle from the outside half. And another big collision as well. Izzy Winter this time. Now Baverstock. Oh, gets away, Baverstock. Thought she was going to free the back door. Scantlebury. So often beats the first defender, Scantlebury. Now Tasker. She steps inside. Another good tackle on her. Hartbury hanging on. Still leading by 10. 15 minutes to go. It's now Loughborough start to latch and start to drive. Hartbury still down to 14. Will they have their lead cut in half here? Sally Williams goes again. Williams is over. Has she grounded it? She has not. Heroic defence once more from Hartbury.
Yeah, I think some really nice pick and goes there, but what they need to try and do is keep the speed. They had a really lovely line break and then slowed it down. If they could keep up that pace, Hartbury are going to be on the back foot every time.
The clock keeps ticking. The score remains the same. It's 27-17. That is only as far as Baker. Baker attacks the line. So Loughborough without a 10 for this particular phase. It's been ripped. It has been ripped from Lucy Finch, and this defence from Hartbury, absolutely outstanding. Is it game-winning defence? Is it championship-winning defence? That's a carry from Webster, goodness me. She's made a good 10 metres there, she had no right to make. Now, how do they exit here, Hartbury? They're kicking into the wind, it's a tough kick. Doing it with great gain line at the moment. Evie Roach, the latest to go. Oh, Weaver. I think she's just put her hands beyond the ball there, so still with Hartbury. We're really bravely carrying. That was Katie Harrison. Oh, another fabulous turnover. Lucy Weaver, off she goes. Georgina Tasker in behind her.
You can see they just wanted to keep the tempo of the game up here.
Playing in the right areas. Lawn across to Greensmith. Greensmith round the outside. Serious gas from Greensmith, who scores. The lead is cut in half. And we have got a game on our hands.
I think that's just from building that pressure, and they finally get their score, and so well deserved. They do deserve that score, and brilliant try.
Brilliant try. They've been down in that 22 for a while now, and not come away with points, so yeah, I think they've done really well here to come on and come away with those points from Freya. Really great footwork and some really good speed to be around the edge.
Well, you have got to back yourself big time to take the long way around there. Oh, just then I was thinking, put it down. Daisy Aspinall did well, though, didn't she, to make sure she couldn't go under the posts.
Yeah, definitely. Well, I think those extra 10 centimetres in might make a difference. You never know.
Baker. Oh, it's close. It's close. It's gone under the crossbar. Yeah. Hartbury 27, Loughborough 22. 11 minutes to go. And it is a contest that we really hoped it'd be.
It's a 5-point game now.
Hartbury still down to 14 for another minute or so. So Ellen Scantlebury has come off. I think all of Loughborough's wide players have had really good days today as that's taken on the fall by Baker.
Great foot there from Sally Williams.
And she's won the penalty advantage for a high tackle by Hartbury. Look at Lucy Weaver just trying to get tempo into the game. That's been knocked on, so we'll go back for the penalty. Pip Hendy, the guilty party. Oh, by the way, something we've not spoken about yet is you two are in charge of the player of the match.
Are we?
Yep.
Oh, wow, that's a high pressure, isn't it?
That is a lot of pressure. I think there's some really great performers out here today.
There's definitely a few people to think about, especially maybe with number twos on their back.
Yeah, I did think that.
Still 10 minutes to go, though. Still so much rugby to be played. Loughborough with the wind at their backs, Hartbury with the scoreboard in their favour. Oh, Loughborough have got to the front. Another carry by Fitzpatrick. Sure, she'll be in the conversation as well. Out the back they go to Baker. Now Freya McCall finds the try scorer, Greensmith. Greensmith evades Pip Hendy. It takes Loughborough back into the 22. That's Poppy Phillips on wearing number 20. It's good line speed this by Hartbury. They must be absolutely exhausted. They've done so much defending in this second half. Oh, the ball over the top is a beauty! And Sally Williams is closing in on the equalising try! What a tackle! What a tackle by Hartbury, potentially championship saving. Oh my goodness, they've turned her on her back like a turtle, and it's still Hartbury 27, Loughborough 22.
Sally's so good when she gets herself on the edges there. She stepped back inside. Some really great defense there.
Sophie Davis. Take a bow. If anything, Sally could perhaps have been penalised there for taking a second bite once she'd been tackled. Changes coming in for Hartbury. They're back up to 15 because Anouk Veerkamp is back on and Agatha Jow is returning to the field of play as well.
Yeah, I think she ended herself there with holding her up over the line, but fantastic skill. And we're seeing it more and more with this new rule in rugby. And I think it makes it so exciting. So exciting.
Well, look, there's still 8.5 minutes of rugby to be played, but Sophie Davis in her final appearance in a Hartbury jersey to make a contribution like that, a try-saving contribution, fantastic.
Things like that will win or lose you a final, and that was a really unbelievable effort from her.
Just hope she's okay now. She's still down at the moment.
Well, what twists and turns are still to come? It'll be a goal line dropout. And Hartbury doing what Loughborough managed to do for so much of the first half. The defensive aptitude, just putting it on the line, you know?
I think there's a good opportunity here for Loughborough to get that possession back. As much as they didn't come away with the score there, they are still down in the 22. And we'll see what they can do with this. I think they've done really well building phases.
going through the motion, it's just now executing that try or getting some points.
Especially with the backs you've got, when they're running onto that ball, they are absolutely lethal. So actually for them, receiving a kick in the opposition's half is very exciting.
Yeah, we've got some really great players out there like Georgina Tasker, who loves a defence, who are on their kick chase, and I think she can find any gaps with some really brilliant footwork. So yeah.
She's back on her feet. I think she'll want to continue. I knew she was carrying bumps and bruises into this game, but her kind of physicality is so important in a young team. And there's the dropout. And here come Loughborough, Georgina Tasker, hands on it straight away to Baker. And now Bo Westcombe-Evans. She's standing a bit further in field now, trying to get her hands on the ball. Weaver arrives, Phillips, Baker again. No space for her, thanks to Kelsey Webster. Oh, knock on. Error strewn from Loughborough, and another chance goes begging.
Yeah, I always find it interesting at the moment. A certain referee seem to read it differently of whether a strip is a knock-on or whether it's just a strip, which I think is quite interesting.
Yes, yes. That's really good pressure there from Hartbury's support, Osiris from Loughborough here, and I think we're thankful here to get the ball and have an opportunity to exit.
Well, they really turned it on in the last scrum as well, so I wonder if they might leave this in, try and milk that penalty, get some field position. They hardly had any. But they still lead 27-22, but they go quickly. That was Agatha Zhao. Oh, a little chip into space. Charlie May mans, and it hasn't worked out. It's gone back to Tasker. Now Tasker, is there a gap here for Loughborough? Kerfey. Lovely handling, it's Atkinson and the big forwards linking up. Baker needs to clear out and does. That's an outside half going above and beyond, and then it's knocked on again by Fitzpatrick. Loughborough running out of time, running out of opportunities.
We've had one by pink, one by red, scrum red.
They are coping with that little chip over really well, because the space is there, but the backs working back are just phenomenal with how quickly they're getting there.
Talk to me about the thought process there, though, because maybe it's because they're kicking into the wind, but surely the temptation for Charlie Maymans, great kicker, is just put a shoe on it.
Yeah, I think the wind is having a big impact. You can see the flags in the stand. It's really picked up a little bit. And maybe it's a message. You never know. If the coaches are saying, look, let's play, that might be why they're doing that.
Mind! Set!
Scrum on the 22 for Hartbury. 6 minutes away from history. Akita Zhao, that went through the legs. She recovered well. And now there is a clearance kick. Now there's a big chase coming too. Baker with work to do and does so well. Freya McCall wrestled to the ground by Daisy Aspinall. The outstanding Daisy Aspinall for Hartbury. Hartbury straight over that. Oh, Amy Dale. Like a barnacle on a boat. You can't shift it. That's massive. Absolutely huge.
You talk about momentum shifts and game-changing moments, that could very well be one of them.
And there is the distance on the kick by Charlie Maymans. It feels like an eternity since Hartbury were inside the Loughborough 22. They're yet to score in the second half. It was 27-12 at half-time, 27-22 now. Another score, any score, penalty, drop goal, try, and surely the red ribbons are being tied on the trophy. Robin Davis goes up. Hartbury back to that trusty ball, that faithful ball that's got them to this point where they are on the brink of a third championship in a row. Ryle rips it free. Priestnell, oh, darts and goes. And Charlie Maymans now with options, wants to get it there quickly, but the bouncing ball, will it bamboozle Loughborough? No, it's back in Loughborough hands. Greensmith robs Aspinall. And Alex Baker, oh, has she been dumped into the ground there by Aspinall?
Okay, nothing coming. We'll take a
I think
one.
They were safe. It just wasn't quite over the horizontal, so I think she was safe there.
Watch that clock. Just remember that we're close, but we're not fully linked in with the referee's watch. So we make it just shy of 4 minutes. Now, whilst I'm not going to ask you to select it with the game of the balance, let's pretend this is like the Brit Awards or the Oscars or something. Let's have a few nominations for player of the match.
Yeah, for me, I think two for Loughborough. I've got Sally Williams. I think she's done really amazing for Loughborough, those line breaks. I think Georgina Tassi has done really well with the high balls, being a big distributor as she is. I also think for Hartbury, it goes without saying, Amy Dale has done unbelievable for them today. Try scorer, working really hard with her hands, some balls to the air, she's done really well. Jess Kershaw, another one out there, done really well for Hartbury today. Yeah, it's a lot of names.
Great defensive pressure. Loughborough penned in their own 22, having spent so much time in Hartbury's. Oh, Baker has coughed that up. And is that the ball game?
Oh, goodness gracious me, this is exciting.
Two and a half minutes to go. Oh, Daisy Aspinall has come over to deliver a message there. And then, 40 pacing around like a caged cat in a zoo. He doesn't know how to keep still.
I think this might be coming blind.
Yeah, Daisy Aspinall fancies a one-on-one. Oh no, they have gone open. So Ryle finds Charlie May Mans, and that's been left behind as well. But again, 78 minutes, a knock-on. It's going to be another minute swallowed up by the scrum.
And that's the thing, Hartbury aren't chasing this game, Loughborough. So actually, for Hartbury, these scrums aren't that bad because they're wasting that, they're bringing that clock down. It's Loughborough that are then going to be feeling the pressure every time this has to set.
We saw it in the men's final earlier. Loughborough led by four. Exeter were in pretty much this exact position here. They needed a try. They didn't have any time. They couldn't kick. You kick, the ball goes dead. The game's over. Nobody on the short side for Loughborough. Everybody on the open side. Massive scrum. Oh, look at the pressure coming in from Hartbury. They've got the advantage. They've got the penalty. And they've got one hand on the trophy. And if you go for the posts here, you can take up the final minute of the clock.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that's very much a story of this game, isn't it? I think it kind of summarises it really nicely that set piece is the thing that's getting Hartbury that final penalty.
Well, with that in mind, shall we have our Women's National League player of the match?
For me, I think that's Amy Dale. Amy Dale today is unbelievable. She's try scorer twice. She's led the team really well. Really good leader within the group. She plays some really great rugby. Really good defensive player. Yeah, for me, she's my player of the match.
Yeah, 100% agree. For a hooker to have the skill set she does and bring that to the team and just lead them and constantly be able to pick them up and make those momentum shifts is absolutely phenomenal and hugely deserved.
Completely agree.
Well, she's not just the player of the match. She is going to be getting her third Bucks gold medal in a row. A phenomenal achievement. An unprecedented achievement in the Women's National League era. And with that,
I'm back on.
There is the player of the match. I tell you what, they've had to patch her up a bit, haven't they? She's taken an absolute bashing, but she's left everything out there. What more could you possibly ask for from a player in red? Charlie Maymans. To stretch it beyond a converted try. Oh, it's hit both posts and come out. The ball is still alive. The match is still in the balance.
No, leave red.
Unbelievable. Well, Loughborough still with a long way to go. Hartbury battling for this ball.
Leave it.
Off one post. post, the other, and down. Penalty to Loughborough. Incredible drama.
You didn't see that coming, did you? And there's Big Ben.
Well, they've done about as well as they can to get some meters there, Loughborough. Now, your Hartpury in this line-out, are you boosting? Are you competing?
100%. You are competing and you are getting up and you're trying to disrupt that ball as much as possible.
Loughborough have gone to the front. Lily Ives, champion, can barely watch. Well, we believe there is still about 2 minutes to go. Oh, it's been knocked on. And Hartbury have picked up the rebound. Oh, Grizzle Johnson nearly got the try that clinches it. And Loughborough have conceded the penalty. They put hands beyond the ball.
They want to play.
And Priestnell. Zhao, a try here would seal it. Just a metre to go. Tilly Ryle wants to get her hands on it. So does Veerkamp. Veerkamp is over! Veerkamp seals it for Hartbury. It is done and dusted. And the trophy is heading back to Gloucestershire. Well, they have weathered an African violent storm for 40 minutes in this second half. But they've hung in, they've held on. And every tackle, every phase, every moment was worth it. And Nuke Veerkamp, what a moment for her, what a game for her. Such a great first half, so much physicality. A yellow card that turned the game on its head. And there she is at the end. All smiles because she has sealed it for Hartbury. Well, Charlie Mayman's from pretty much the exact same spot where she hit both posts moments ago. Makes no mistake this time. And the bench is empty. The celebrations begin because Hartbury have made history. The only name on the trophy in the Women's National League era. It's three in a row, it's triple trouble. And the full-time score from the StoneX Stadium, Hartbury 34, Loughborough 22. What a brilliant game of rugby, what a fantastic contest, and what a wonderful advert for rugby at this level.
100%. Credit to both of these teams, they gave it their absolute all. And you know what? What a wonderful place the women's game is in. This just demonstrates the depth that's coming through, the resources and the finances that's working, and we're creating an incredible product.
Incredible product and incredible memories. These champions here, tears from the player of the match, Amy Dale. I mean, she's busted up and banged up, but she was phenomenal today.
Completely, and she is a player that wears her heart on her sleeve and gives everything for her team and her teammates, and you can see that today. You can see it from the face, the war wound just says it all.
Overwhelmed with emotion, a player of the match, and she will have a third gold medal for her collection. Let's take a look at the highlights, of which there were plenty. The heartbreak. Dominant for so long, and Loughborough dared to dream. Seems like a long time ago now, this first try, doesn't it? But it's Amy Dale. You've talked us through it a number of times before, but let's talk about the wider ball, because it really was a weapon for Hartbury today.
Yes, their set piece is so crucial to how they play, and I think it's just so fitting that that's what got them over the line so many times. That's what built the pressure and ultimately won them the game.
Well, that was the basis for so much of the good stuff. Oh, my goodness. Back in the days when both of her cheeks were the same size, Amy Dale, she took a wallop earlier. This was the second. It was actually a great take, wasn't it? The lift was a little bit early, but the recovery from there on in, absolutely sensational. This was a Liv Constable.
Yeah, again, shows the depth. Your replacement who can come on and absolutely nail it and do a job, score the try. Phenomenal work.
Well, at that point, it was 12-0, and Hartpury were absolutely cruising. They'd shown that they were dominant up front, but now a little bit of Charlie May man's magic, finished off by Daisy Aspinall. But what about that offload? Allo Pierce, hands through the line. Lucia Scott, we wish her all the best with her recovery. But we have seen some very special young talents for Hartpury today.
Some incredible young talent and some talent that I think we'll be seeing a lot more of over the coming years.
This was Sally Williams. Well, she's wearing number 8, but she could wear pretty much any number. Serious talent player.
Again, so exciting. So exciting that you've got a back row player with that pace and that energy to get around and want to beat people.
Well, Hartbreak just kept on coming. They were relentless. It truly was a game of two halves, because it felt as though Loughborough spent as much time in the 22 as Hartbury did in the first half. But Claire Grizzle Johnson got her try off a lovely seed from Amy Dale. But Loughborough just refused to quit. That was a weird one, wasn't it? Off the shins of Molly Anderson Thomas, and then a clean pair of heels from Kendall Wardby.
Yeah, and what's brilliant is that they didn't stop. They didn't go, oh, mistake, we need to panic. They stuck with each other, they played together, and then they got the reward.
And Hartbury got their reward for some stern scrummaging at the end of the half, and it was Dale over again. And that took us through to half-time, 27-12. And you asked the question, how valuable will that win be? Well, we very nearly found out, didn't we? It was all Loughborough in the second half. It was Isla Curfew who got the first try. And given how well Loughborough spread the ball, given how well we saw their speedsters, that was brute strength. Brilliant.
100%. That is just individual want.
Yes.
And do you know what? Rugby is so much about that.
And then they did manage to put some width on it. This was Freya Greensmith, a second half substitution with a lot of work to do, and she did it. And at that point we thought, oh, maybe, just maybe, that was 27-22, and we had a phenomenal contest on our hands.
We did. We were not left short of a final, were we?
Well, there was one more try. In fact, there were a few more twists in the tail, including a penalty that bounced off both. But then this was the last try. It was Anouk Veerkamp, another player who had an excellent game, and that's the reward.
Yeah, 100%. I think it says a lot about this team. Time was up then, but they wanted to carry on playing and they wanted to finish on top, and I think that's testament to their mindset.
Full-time score, Hartbury 34, Loughborough 22. They're getting ready for the trophy presentation, but before that, let's hear from the panel who are down there with LJ.
Thanks very much, Dave. I've got to speak to the girls first and foremost about the disappointment of Loughborough. Two Loughborough University girls here, and Amelia, I'll come to you first. I sat next to you throughout that second half and it looked like they were going to do it. How many chances were squandered there and how disappointed will they be?
I think there was three chances maybe where they could have scored, and it was just little silly little errors that just ruined it for them, which is so disappointing. I know they're going to be absolutely gutted. At the end there, it was exhilarating. I thought they were going to score after full time, but obviously, I mean, Hartbury do deserve it, and Amy Dale getting man of the match, she really deserves it. She was an amazing player, but yeah, no, absolutely gutted.
And in commentary, it must have been as exhausting as playing, because that was one of the most frenetic second halves we've seen in a long time.
I had to put my mic down. It was, honestly, it was, what a crazy game. But you know what, that's the type of game we want this final to be, and that is the final that everyone wants to see. And I think both teams came at this really hard, and obviously Hartbury came away with the win there, but you can't, Loughborough did really well there in the end, and they really fought back, and just what a great game that was for both teams. And I think both teams should be really happy with the performance they put out there. Obviously it's a final, so win or lose, but I think again, like, for where we are within the league and how far we've come, I think this is a great opportunity and a really great game of rugby to show that. Just Hartbury came away with the win there.
Sorry, go ahead. Amelia, before the game, you said you either win or you learn, which I thought was really interesting. What will Loughborough take from this going forward in the Women's National League?
Well, it's just a huge achievement regardless, getting to the final. I know many other teams would have dreamt of being here tonight. So it is just kind of appreciating that they did get this far and learning from execution, I think, will be their main goal now. executing it when they get into that try zone.
Yeah. We have to talk about the winners, the three-peat. Hartbury are the only team in the men's and women's competitions to ever do this three times in a row. How special a team are they?
Oh, wow. They have done unbelievable today. They have played really well. They've been really physical, as we knew they were going to be. Really direct, and that's just the game they like to play. They play it so well. Loughborough in the first half, as we saw, didn't react to it as well, probably as quick as they could have done. Quite high penalty count, but I think Hartbury then ran away with that a little bit in the first half. But second half, again, a really good competition between them both. But they just were a little bit more pinnacle today to get that try and get that extra try.
And Hartbury will feel like they've done this through adversity, because the amount of injuries they had in that second half really felt like it unsteadied the ship for them. But they've still managed to come away with such an impressive win here on finals day.
Completely. And I think having an injury like that for the team is really hard. And to come back, there's like a complete stop of momentum of the game, and to come back into the game, it was probably going to be a little bit slow to start. But they managed it so well, and they have some amazing players in there, some really young players in there as well. And I think they credit themselves, they did amazing. Players like Amy Dell, for example, leader within that group. Is she graduating this year? Is she graduating? I think just for her, this is her third title with that team. It's amazing. Incredible. And you've got young players like Daisy Aspinall, again, who did really well for her.
Well, let's go back to Dave Rogers, who's in commentary. He's going to lead us through the trophy presentation.
The officials have just been presented with their mementos, the team of Rebecca Piddleston, Melissa Wright, Emily Hope and Casey Allen. But Amy Dale is given player of the match. What a phenomenal performance. What a phenomenal career in the red of Hartbury. Three Bucks championships. Two tries, one player of the match. One sore face in the morning, but it'll all be worth it. What a performance. And it needed it today as well. It needed the biggest and best players to perform. Hartbury, we saw how great that 23 was, but they were players with limited experience. They were dragged forwards by those with the experience. And they certainly brought the best out of them. But what about our runners-up? They received their silver medals. And it's a programme that's going somewhere under Katie Trevathan. Third in the league, their best ever finish. First final. Knocked out in the quarters last year, Georgina Tasker there. She was, well, in the conversation for player of the match. She was outstanding, as was Alex Baker. And what about that Sally Williams try that really gave Loughborough hope? And there was hope too. Steph Atkinson, Canada eligible. She's got a big future. As has Lucy Weaver. I mean, she's played so much Premiership women's rugby this year. Quite the Weaver dynasty in the night jersey. But just looking at the expressions on the Loughborough faces, these are smiles on faces. And by the looks of things, they're pretty happy with the season, despite the disappointment of today's result. Rightly so. Well, the full-time score of 34-22. It's actually a much closer game than that. It was a try with the last play to take it away from them, but they had their chances. But there's no point having any regrets. It's Keevy Fitzpatrick. She was outstanding today as well. Immense work rate. And then Freya McCall, one of that trio of backline replacements who came on, really lit up this game. Erin Proctor, the club chairperson, final year student, who's been recognised by Students RFU today for her fantastic contribution to the game outside of the white lines. She leaves with a well-deserved medal. And of course, the obvious task of going one better next year. But with the programme they've got, the coaches, the players, the support, and of course the dynasty, the phenomenal talent that have come through Loughborough in the past, who's to say they can't? The first final for Loughborough ends in defeat. But what of Hartbury? If there is something in rugby to be won, it generally feels like they win it. In both men's and women's rugby, they have been the trendsetters in the student game. First men's team to get into the championship, the first men's team to win Bucks Super Rugby, the first women's team to win the Women's National League. And they haven't looked back. First under the stewardship of Mo Hunt, then Andrew Ford. Of course, it all feeds into Gloucester Hartbury, Premiership champions. It's just a phenomenal rugby factory that keeps on delivering great players, great teams, great coaches, great moments. And there is another one today, another crop of current stars, future stars. And what moments, what joy did they provide us with? They had to dig in for that one. You'd have thought at 27-12 half-time it was done and dusted, but that's very rarely the Bucks way. And the best of luck, of course, to those players like Lucia Scott, who picked up injuries today. Massive futures, but of course they're in good hands, they'll recover well. And they will be back, make no mistake. See Evie Roach there at the back, captaining for the second time in a final, playing for the third time in a final. And she is going to lift that trophy with great pride. For many of these players, a great way to sign off. For even more, an inspiration to do it all again next year. It's three in a row. The dynasty continues. How far can it go? Hartbury, the history makers, the only name on that trophy. They dig deep, they find a way. Born winners. Well, the celebrations continue with Hartbury. It's almost like they never end. Phenomenal performance, phenomenal season, and a phenomenal team. Hartbury are the National Cup champions. Oh, well, don't go anywhere yet, because we are going to be hearing from the coaches and the player of the match, Amy Dale. But let's just talk about what a moment this is. We could talk about all the positivity, blah, blah, this, that and the other, but we've got a group of champions there. They're going to celebrate tonight and they deserve it. But look, you're a senior player now. You've played for three of the biggest teams in rugby, really. What do you make of all this then? University rugby provided this kind of quality. Well, one of those amazing players is Amy Dale, the player of the match, who is down there with Bernsey.
Amy Dale, three times Women's National League winner, two tries in this final and player of the match. Wow.
It's incredible. I have no words, really. I'm so emotional and just full of emotion. Playing with your best friends on a Wednesday night, you know, under the lights, it's just a feeling like no other.
That was an incredible game. Incredible game for us to watch. Bit nerve-wracking for you. What was it like being out there?
It was just, you know, some parts were manic. We had to calm it down a bit. We had to slow down the pace. We know Loughborough like to play with a lot of pace, especially playing edge to edge. So we struggled to get into that rhythm, matching it at first, but I think we really stepped up to the plate. And we just gave them a good competition.
And, you know, I feel like I'm looking at the obvious part of your anatomy here, but it looked brutal out there at times as well.
Yeah, it was brutal, but that fight to say, you know, I need to be on that pitch. I need to get back out on that pitch. That's what I felt. You've got to give it your all in these games. You've got to come off like you've got nothing else to give. And credit to all of the girls. We had a few with injuries, Liv Constable, Lucia Scott, but credit, they gave their all, and I can't ask for any more, really.
And look, let's just talk about Hartpury as a whole. I know you want to get off to everyone, but three times back to back, you've been a part of each and every single one. How special is it to have been on this journey with Hartpury?
Oh, so special. I mean, I remember my first year, we were the underdogs of the season. Never really thought we'd get here. But the journey we've come on, the connection we have with the squad is like no other. We have each other's backs. You know, we're all the bestest of friends, and we all just want to go out on a pitch and support each other and do what we can for each other. So, yeah, it's incredible.
And I feel that I'm robbing your adoring fans of time with their star. We are hooked like them, and you're our player of the match. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you. I really appreciate it. Thank you.
Righto. Back up to you, D-Rog.
Cheers, Burnsy. How great is it to hear a player like that just so pleased with the performance, so happy to be part of a team? And she talks about her first year. They were underdogs. They went to Loughborough the first game. We live streamed it, and they got absolutely battered, but they built and built. And just to hear the joy in her voice at the end of a job well done is wonderful.
That's what it's all about. At the end of the day, we do this because it's the sport we love and it's with the people we love. And that just epitomises rugby for me. And I think it does everybody.
Quite the boo-boo on the cheek, isn't it?
Honestly, she's hard as nails. Let's not get it wrong. Hard as nails. And fair play for her to keep getting up and keep going.
Well, Burnsy is actually, he must have his roller skates on or something, because he's caught the fastest man in show business. 40's down there. Burnsy, what's he got to say?
Not roller skates, but motivated by the chill that is blowing through here, but also by the fact that I managed to collar the main man who masterminded that victory across the season and when it mattered most today against really tough opposition.
Yeah, I got a bit lost for words, to be honest. Super emotional with that group. Look, to be honest with us, we haven't had much prep time the last couple of weeks, and the girls just knew that they just had to dig deep, trying to keep it simple, stupid, just get after the basics. Driving Maul, scrum were outstanding. Lewis Arnold's come in the last couple of weeks and built on what the girls have been working on, and wow, you get to that set piece. The set piece was phenomenal, but honestly, the defensive effort, there's girls coming into this game hobbling and patched up, and some of them did 80 minutes today, and you know, one of them, Sophie Davis, her try-saving tackle at the end was phenomenal, considering she pretty much got stretched off in our last game to come back on this pitch, and it's her last game. So massive shout out to Soph. Honestly, couldn't be prouder of the staff and the players in this group. It's fantastic.
An incredible achievement, an incredible match, and you know, you came blasting out of the blocks, but Loughborough really brought the noise. How pleased are you with the character of your side to weather storm after storm that came from Loughborough?
Yeah, I think one of the big things we got after this year was resilience with this group, and it's something we really chased after. Look, we knew we were in a fight, and when you're in a fight, you can throw the first few punches, but you know they're going to hit you back. And wow, they came back second half. Their handling under pressure was phenomenal from Loughborough. And we just had to dig deep and try and force as many errors and try and get back up the pitch. I mean, thankfully we did towards the end. I'm sure me and Charlie will chat about the hitting both posts. But no, honestly, couldn't be prouder. And look, you know, at the end of the day, you know, we've won that fight, and I couldn't be prouder of them.
You've won that fight and you've won a third consecutive championship. How much does this mean to Hartbury as an institution? I mean, I'm sure you won't mind sharing. There are tears in your eyes at the final whistle from you personally as well.
Yeah, I think it's just an emotional, what this group has been through this year, both on and off the field, is phenomenal. And they've been through it this year, and getting up every morning, you know, 7 a.m, getting onto the training pitch, getting in the gym when it's dark, it's wet, it's cold, all leads up to these 80 minutes. And when you ask them to leave it out here, and we said, do not come off this pitch with regrets, you've not left anything out here. And I can certainly say they left everything out here, so couldn't be prouder.
Small celebration tonight?
Yeah, I think we might get a quick bus back to Gloucester and see what happens.
That is the hottest ticket in town, on the Hartpury bus on the way back to Gloucester. I will leave you to get with your team and start those celebrations in earnest. What a finals day here at the StoneX. It's up to you, D-Rog, to bring us home.
Well, that's it. The curtain falls on another incredible season of Bucks Super Rugby and the Women's National League. Hartbury with the three-peat, Loughborough with the heartbreak. In the men's, Exeter denied history, and Loughborough lift the trophy for the first time. Another incredible season of memories, of moments, and of incredible rugby. We'll be back next year. But until then, the buck stops here.